Welcome to the Prophecy Club, where we study and research Bible prophecy. Our topic tonight is called Wake Up America, and we're even going to call it version 2 to differentiate it from the previous videotape we've made of Dimitru Duduman. I believe that Isaiah 13 and Revelation 18 and Jeremiah 50 and 51 are all speaking of America. And one day I ran across Dimitru Duduman and did nothing but just confirm what I felt like the scripture said. And in introducing him tonight, I normally make the introduction very brief, but in this case I've had some personal experiences that I feel like all people need to know so that they can believe a little bit more deeply in the fact that he is telling the truth, the message is in fact from God. So I'll give you four reasons why I believe. Reason number one happened in March of 1988. I drove over here to Kansas City, and I picked up Dimitri and his grandson interpreter, Michael Boldea. We were driving from Kansas City to Topeka, and about 10 or 15 minutes down the freeway, Dimitri kind of laid his head back, and I thought he was probably just taking a nap. And directly he turns to me, and he says, through his interpreter, he says, "This woman in your life." And I said, "Yes, my wife." He said, "You tell her. First, she must pray for strength for herself before she prays for other people. She's praying for other people, and their problems are coming back on her. She must pray for strength for herself before she prays for other people." Well, what would you think? Some stranger get in the car and says this to you. So I thought, okay, fine. Well, about an hour later, we arrived at Dilly's. Was Dilly's then at 5th and Topeka. They went in, sat down, and they began ordering, and I stepped out in the foyer and called my wife long distance. And at that particular time, we were moving into our new home in Omaha, Nebraska. And I called and I said, "Honey, I said, I don't know if this is going to mean anything to you or not, but let me tell you what this guy just told me. He said that before you pray for other people, he says you're supposed to pray for yourself. He says that you're praying for other people and their problems are coming back on you. Does that mean anything to you?" And she just started crying. She said, "Oh, yeah." She said, "I've just been opening these boxes and just putting everything up, and just whoever comes to mind, I've just been praying for them. I'm so down and so depressed." And I thought, wow. You know, he hit it. How in the world could a man driving down the interstate in Kansas know the secret, silent prayers of a woman in Omaha, Nebraska? A man can't. But through the Spirit of God, he can. So this told me I had someone very special in the car. The next incident happened as we were driving around. He told me many things. But one of the things he told me, he said that the angel told him that before the problems come to America, that Romania would have a revolution. Well, that didn't mean a lot to me. You know, I was interested in finding out what was going to happen to America. So I kind of tucked that on the back burner and forgot about it. But 1 year and 9 months later, I'll never forget it. December 22nd, 1989, 8:30 in the morning. I was still in bed. My back was hurting. And here comes on the news, CNN. Ceausescu's been shot. Romania's having a revolution. And I sat up in bed and I started to let this thought come out. Oh, no, it's true. But I knew it was true. And I thought, but it's so close. And about that time, the phone right beside me rang, and I reached over and picked it up. "Hello, is my mom calling long distance from Texas?" And she says, "Are you watching the news?" And I said, "Yes, as a matter of fact, I am." She says, "About the Romanian revolution." And I said, "Yes, as a matter of fact, I am. Why?" And she said, "Didn't you tell me that was going to happen?" And I said, "Yes, I did." She says, "Okay, tell me again. What else did you say?" And I said, "Well, it wasn't me that was saying, it was Dimitru Duduman, but here's what the message is." That afternoon, I walked into the office, and the secretary said, "Have you been reading the newspapers?" I said, "No, I normally watch CNN for my news. Why?" She said, "Well, have you heard Romania is having a revolution?" And I said, "Yes, why?" And she said, "Well, didn't you tell me that was going to happen?" And I said, "Yes, I did." She says, "Okay, tell me again, what else did you say? And of course I said, well, it wasn't me that said it. Come from Dimitru Duduman, but here's what he said. And now she listens. There's two more people in the world listen as a result of that. And of course, what's the message for us? If he can foretell a Romanian revolution, obviously the angel can foretell many other things too. The next thing that happened was, later on that year, I had the opportunity to go out to his home in Fullerton, California. And we were out front in the front lawn mingling and talking. And I was impressed to just ask him about a detail in his story. As you recall in his story, he says that the very first night he got to America, the apartment stunk. He was outside sitting on a rock, he said, and a light started coming toward him. And he said he thought it was a Romanian police trying to run over him. He was used to that, and so he jumped to run. And he said all of a sudden, the light surrounded him, and out of the light, it was the same voice. It was the same angel. Well, as we were sitting there, I thought, well, I wonder where he was sitting that night. So I turned to him, and I said, Dimitri, where were you sitting the night that you thought the light was coming at you, with the first night the angel came to talk to you? And he walked over. He took about 8 steps over and sat down on what we would call a brick planter. And as he sat there, I remember his head, he was kind of looking around and kind of getting his bearing to make certain he was sitting in exactly the right place. And I sat down beside him and I said, now, exactly where did the light come from? And he pointed from right there, that particular angle. And I said, oh, well, that's real interesting. And I changed the subject and we went on talking. Well, in a little while, he got up. And being the inquiring mind that I am, checking out his story, I walked over and sat in the very spot he sat. And I asked myself one question. From where I was sitting and from where the light came, would I mistake that as a car? See, those little details, if someone was just making up a story, wouldn't be there. Well, I sat there and I looked at where he pointed the light to come from, and absolutely, he was telling the truth. Now, why do I say that? Because the light was coming right down a road. You see, there's a road that just dead ends right into his house, and the person has to either turn right or turn left. If they keep going straight, they would literally drive right into his front living room and run right over where he was sitting on that brick planter. So exactly as he had said, the story matched. You could look up, you could see a light coming from that direction and easily mistake that for a car or something. The fourth example happened about a year later. We invited him to speak up in Omaha, and I was going to take him around to several churches and things like that also. And it was a Monday night, and I think it was January or February of the year, because it got dark pretty early. And I just dropped him off at Living Faith Church. Brother Wes Doffenbaugh is the pastor there. It was a Monday night. And I think I dropped him off like about probably 6:30 or something. And then we were heading home. At the time, and I can remember the very spot in the highway where this conversation took place. We were heading south on Interstate 680. We just passed the Pacific Street exit, for those of you that are familiar with Omaha. We just passed Pacific Street, and Leslie, my wife, turned and she says, now, I don't want you to think that I don't believe that Dimitri is from God, because I do. She says, but if he was really a man from God, he would have a message for me. You know, he has his messages for you and all these other people, and here's what God says to you, and here's what God says to you. If he was really a man from God, he would know that I wanted a message from God, and he would give me a message from God. And I said, well, I said, honey, I said, you know, ask him. He'll tell you. And of course, you have to understand, Dimitri, when he prays, he either gets an audible voice in the ear, or an angel comes and taps him on the hand and wakes him up in the middle of the night and gives him the answer. And I suppose that if you and I had been through some of the things he'd been through, perhaps God would deal with us that way also. Anyway, and I said, no, I said, you know, you ask him, he'll tell you. And she says, no, if he was really a man from God, he would know that I want a prophecy and he would give me a message. And I said, well, I said, honey, I think that's stretching a little bit. Just ask him. She says, no. If he's really a man from God, he will know that I want a message, and he'll give me a message from God. That was Monday night, 6:30. Now, Friday night, each Friday night, we had a Bible study over at our house, and typically 10, 12, At the most, 15 people would show up for the Bible study. Well, this particular night, they heard Dimitru Duduman was coming, and we had about 50 people show up. And, of course, that was a lot of folks at that time. This was long before the Prophecy Club started. And there were so many people, we thought it better to move two houses down to another brother's house. And I remember Dimitri taught that night on Galatians 5. When he was done, I was in the kitchen helping get drinks and tea and things like that for some of the guests. And he walked up to my wife, Leslie, and he pointed his finger at her and said, "You said, if I'm a man from God, I would have a message from God for you. Well, what would you do?" And he began to tell her all the secrets of her heart. "I do hear your prayers. I do talk to you." And on, things that meant something to her. Well, of course, she come running in the kitchen where I was. And she said, "Did you talk to Dimitri about me wanting a message from God?" I said, "No." I said, "He's been gone all week long, across town visiting friends and all. No, I haven't talked to him. Why?" She said, "Now, you're sure you didn't tell him that I wanted a message from God?" And I said, "No, I haven't spoken to him. Why?" She said, "Well, let me tell you what he just did." Now, here's four good examples as to why we need to hear this message. And folks, I'll tell you right now, a lot of people don't like hearing hard messages. They only want to hear the smooth things, the things that tickle their ears. They can't stand to hear that the wages of sin is still death. Well, I want to tell you that God's still on the throne and all of His laws are still quite well in place. So with that as an introduction, help me welcome Dimitru Duduman and his interpreter, Michael Boldea.
Binecuvântat să fie în numele lui Dumnezeu, Tatăl nostru, Domnul nostru Iisus Hristos și Duhul Sfânt. Amin.
Blessed be the name of God the Father, Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Nu-i bun.
Not good enough.
Amin.
Amen.
Așa, băi, fraților.
Better brothers.
Eu nu țin cont că-s la televizor aici, că acum e în biserică.
It doesn't matter if they're filming this. I still feel like I'm in church.
Vrem să vă vedem plin de viață.
So I want to see you full of life.
Să fiți plin de bucurie că l-aveți pe Hristos.
I want to see you full of joy that you have Christ in your hearts.
Atunci omul e supărat că nu l-are pe Hristos.
The only time a man should be sad is when he doesn't have Jesus.
Cuvântul lui Dumnezeu spune așa.
Because the word of God says this.
Cum Dumnezeu a uns pe Iisus Hristos din Nazaret cu Duhul Sfânt și cu putere.
As God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power.
Care mergea din loc în loc,
who went from place to place,
și vindeca pe toți cei ce apărsați de diavol,
and healed all those that were oppressed of the devil,
Dumnezeu era cu el,
because God was with him.
Fraților,
brothers,
vrem să vorbim prima dată cu relativ la lucrarea Duhului Sfânt.
First, I would like to speak about the work of the Holy Spirit.
După care voi spune testimoniul.
After which I will tell you my testimony.
Dar ceea ce are nevoie America,
but what America needs today,
are nevoie de lucrarea Duhului Sfânt să fie curată,
is for the work of the Holy Spirit to be clean.
Amen.
Amen.
Nu vrem rătăciri.
We don't want to be deceived.
Nu vrem imitații.
We don't want to be imitating people.
Vrem lucrarea lui Dumnezeu să fie curată.
We want the true and clean work of God in our lives.
Și ca să ai lucrarea curată a lui Dumnezeu,
in order to have the true work of God,
trebuie să trăiești viața curată.
Brother, you must live the life.
Amen.
Amen.
Domnul Hristos înainte de a se înalța la cer.
Jesus Christ before going up to heaven.
În Faptele Apostolilor capitolul 1.
In Acts chapter 1.
Stă de vorbă cu ucenicii.
Speaks to his apostles.
Și le spune la ucenici clar.
And he says to them very clearly.
Voi nu vă depărtați de templu.
You do not leave the temple.
Până nu veți primi o putere de sus.
Until you receive a power from above.
Dar înainte de asta Hristos le-a fost dat putere.
But before this Christ had given them power.
Au suflat peste ei și au zis, luați duc din Duhul meu.
He had breathed over them and said, take spirit of my spirit.
Dar nu le-a fost de ajuns.
But it was not enough.
O trebuit ca ei să stea în lângă templu.
They had to be beside the temple.
Să stăruiască.
And constantly
să
in God's presence.
Dumnezeu.
Pray to God.
ca Dumnezeu să-i ungă cu Duhul Sfânt.
So that God would anoint them with the Holy Spirit. A lot of American brothers say, I received this Holy Spirit when I received the word.
Nu vă înșelați.
Brother, don't deceive yourself.
Asta e învățătura baptistă.
This is the Baptist teaching.
Dar nu e adevărat.
But brothers, it's not true.
La apostoli au spus, nu vă depărtați de templu.
Because he told the apostles, do not leave the temple.
Până nu veți primi o putere de sus.
Until you receive a power from above.
După ce veți primi această putere.
After receiving this power. You'll be my witnesses in Jerusalem,
in Judea,
and all across the world.
Hallelujah! Și vedem în Faptele Apostolilor capitolul 2.
And we see in Acts chapter 2.
O lucrare minunată a lui Dumnezeu.
A wonderful work of God.
Apostolii s-au strâns în casa lui Marcu.
The apostles all gathered in Mark's house.
Lângă Ierusalim.
Near Jerusalem.
Era un număr de aproape 120 de inși.
A number of about 120 people.
Ei stăruiau.
They were constantly.
În învățătura apostolilor.
Learning from the apostles.
În frângerea pâinii.
Breaking bread.
Și în rugăciuni.
But most of all praying.
S-au rugat timp de 10 zile.
Now they prayed for 10 days, brothers.
La 10-a zi.
And the 10th day.
Dumnezeu le-a făcut
God made them one heart and one thought. And while they prayed, the place where they were actually shook. And tongues as a fire were poured down upon them. And all began to speak in other tongues. As the Spirit instructed them to. But brothers, what tongue were they speaking in? Many people were gathered in Jerusalem. It was the great day of the feast. And they all ran to Mark's house because they'd heard the wind and they'd seen the tongues of fire. Man, let's go see what's happening there. When they got there, brothers, they heard them all speaking miraculous things of God.
Nu vorbeau alte lucruri.
They weren't speaking other things.
Cu toate că auzeau oamenii vorbind lucruri minunate a lui Dumnezeu.
And even though they heard them speaking miraculous things of God.
Ce vrea să zic asta?
What does this mean?
Oamenii ăștia sunt nebuni.
And these people are crazy.
Oamenii ăștia sunt bieți.
Ha, they're just drunk.
Dar Petru, care s-a lepădat în curtea lui Pilat,
but Peter, Christos, who had previously denied Christ at Pontius Pilate's place, because he did not have the power of God.
De data asta, Petru avea puterea.
This time Peter had the power.
Deci, se ridică în picioare,
and he stands up
înaintea tuturor poporilor,
before all the people gathered there.
Bărbați izraeliți,
and he says, Israelite men,
voi care sunteți în Ierusalim,
and you who live in Jerusalem,
ascultați cuvintele mele,
listen to my words.
Oamenii aceștia nu sunt bez, cum ziceți.
These men are not drunk, as you say. For this is only the third hour of the day. But this is what the prophet Joel prophesied. In the days of the end, says the Lord, I will pour from my spirit over every being. Your daughters and your sons will be on drugs. Is that what it says? Brothers, they will prophesy. Your elders will dream dreams. And even over those servants, I will pour from my spirit and they will prophesy.
Amen.
Amen.
Fraților,
brothers,
dar ce se întâmplă în America?
What's happening in America?
Vedem că Dumnezeu a lucrat puternic.
We see that God used to work mightily.
Lucrarea asta e pentru tot până când la timpul de sfârșit.
And God's work is for everyone because these are the end times.
Nu numai la ucenici.
It wasn't only for the apostles.
Asta e o șelătorie.
This is a deceivement.
E și pentru tine.
It is for you.
E și pentru mine.
It is for me.
Dumnezeu dă daruri oamenilor.
God gives gifts to men.
Dar nu cu darul să faci business.
But he doesn't give it that you make a business out of it.
Nu, darul nu e a tău.
The gift is not yours.
Darul e a bisericii.
The gift belongs to the church.
Dacă Dumnezeu ți-o dă.
And if God gave it to you, you must also give it freely to the church. But first and foremost, you must live the life so that the devil will have no place in your heart. Not like how I see in America. Oh, brother, I received the Holy Spirit. How'd you receive it? I walked up. And there's pastors who don't even know what the Spirit of God means. They walk up and they lay hands on your head. And then he said to repeat after him, hey, 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 hey. And that's all you're left with. Brother, you must speak in tongues like you hear me speak. Apostle Paul says every language in the world has understanding.
Dacă nu are nicio înțeles,
if it has no meaning, no understanding,
atunci, zice, voi fi un străin față de el.
Then I will be a stranger toward him.
Darurile lui Dumnezeu, unii din bisericile americane.
Brothers, where are the gifts of God in the American
Vrem
church?
Să fie darurile lui Dumnezeu.
We want to see the gifts of God.
Din cauza vieții voastre.
Because of our lives.
Din cauza că vă place lumea și lucrurile din
because
lume.
We compromise with the world and the things of the world. Because we like things like cigarettes or like alcohol and things that are wicked. And then we want to see angels. Brother, maybe angels of darkness, but not angels of God. Because angels of God come to righteous people. Be ye holy, for I am holy, said Jesus Christ. Be ye holy in all your doings, not only in church, but everywhere you go. Let people see you like they see this light. That's how you should shine. I have put you as lights in the darkness. Because the world doesn't read the Holy Book. The world reads you and they read me. They want to see if what I say, I do. But if the world smokes, so do we. The world drinks, so do we. The world divorces, so do we. Does God like this, brothers? And oh, we wait for salvation. Oh, I am saved. Do you think the fact of raising your hand in a church makes you saved? No. Men came to John the Baptist to be baptized. And he says, sons of vipers, who taught you to run away from the coming wrath? First do deeds worthy of repentance. And then come to me that I may baptize you. Brothers, may God bless you. Don't look at me like you're scared. Instead, be full of joy because God loves you.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Câteva întrebări și pe urmă mă apuc de testimoniu.
A few questions and then I'll start telling you my testimony. Brothers, the people that are gathered here.
Mai există vă unul care fumează?
Is there still anyone among us that smokes?
Prorocul Isaia spune să nu dai bani pe cine nu hrănește.
Prophet Isaiah simply says, do not spend your money on things that don't feed you and on things that are not good for your body.
Și în primul rând, dacă tu spui că ai Duhul Sfânt.
And brother, if you say you have the Holy Spirit.
Duhul Sfânt cum poate să locuiască la un loc cu nicotină?
How can the Holy Spirit cohabitate with the nicotine?
Cum poate să locuiască la un loc cu droguri?
How can it cohabitate with drugs?
Cum poți să locuiască la un loc cu alcool?
How can it cohabitate with alcohol?
De ce spui că ai pe Duhul Sfânt?
Brothers, we have to be cautious when
nu
we speak.
Înșelați, fraților.
Let's not deceive ourselves.
Duhul Sfânt locuiește într-o inimă curată.
The Holy Spirit lives in a holy vessel.
Inima voastră este templul Duhului Sfânt.
And it says, your hearts are the temple of the Holy Spirit.
În noi trebuie să se vadă că există Hristos.
Brothers, we must have fruit. People must see Christ in us.
Dacă Dumnezeu lăsa pe oameni să fumeze,
and if God would let man smoke,
ne face o geagură aici.
We'd all have chimneys on our heads.
Eu vreau să vă întreb dacă cineva vrea să fie eliberat în seara asta.
So my question to you is if anyone wants to be free tonight.
În fața televizorului.
Even though they're filming this.
De ce să mă arăt pe mine în evidență?
Why should I speak only about myself?
Și voi să trăiți mai departe în păcat.
And let you continue to do things that are wrong.
Aduceți țigările aici.
Brothers, bring your cigarettes up here.
De bună voie.
Of your own free will.
Nu forțat.
Not forced.
Din dragoste.
But out of love for God.
Ca să scap de dracu.
That you escape the devil.
Dă divorț de dracu.
Divorce the devil.
Cununete cu Hristos.
Be one with Christ tonight.
În locul nicotinei.
And let the Spirit of God enter you in the place of the nicotine.
Amen. Vine careva.
Anyone coming up?
Hai venit.
Have courage. Yes.
Dacă mă duc să vă iau de mână, vă place?
Would it be better if I went and grabbed you by the arm?
Vă place?
Would it?
Să nu crezi tu că le ascunzi.
Brothers, don't think that you can hide.
Și în ciorap le vede că le bat.
God even sees when you have them in your sock.
Oriunde le ascunzi, Dumnezeu vede.
No matter where you have them, guys, God sees.
Dacă nu vrei să te eliberezi, nu vrei.
But if you don't want to be freed, then don't.
Dar eu te-am rugat.
I did my duty.
Să aduceți țigările aici.
I asked for you to bring them up.
Ca să scăp de acest duh fel de rușine.
So that you may escape this demon, embarrass him in front of everyone.
Mâine poi mâine te văd cu cancer.
Because in a few days, oh, they said, I have cancer. And you come up, brother, pray for me, I have cancer. Brother, first be obedient.
Ascultă Evanghelia care e puterea lui Dumnezeu.
Obey the gospel, which is the power of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Hai, aveți curajul.
Anyone have the courage?
Hai, vă invit. Come on, come on.
My invitation, just come up.
No, vai rușine,
știi? If not, you're embarrassed, I know.
La televizor cu țigara.
I'm not going to be on TV with cigarettes.
Noi, fraților.
Brothers.
Cum ai să apare înaintea lui Dumnezeu?
How will you stand before God?
Dacă vine Hristos la noapte,
if Christ comes tonight,
ești tu gata să-l întâmpini?
Are you ready to meet him in the
ești
air?
Un întâmpinare?
Are you ready?
Cum că spun frați americani că biserica va fi răpită înainte din acazul cel mare?
A lot of American brothers say that the church will be raptured before any sort of tribulation.
Vrem să citim în Biblie.
Brothers, let's document it biblically once and for all. Do you have Bibles?
Aveți?
Do you?
Yes.
Deschideți Biblia.
Then open your Bibles.
Apocalipsa capitolul 7.
To Revelation chapter 7. Revelation.
Nu ne jucăm cu Evanghelia.
Brothers, we cannot play with the gospel.
Și Dumnezeu nu se lasă înșelat de oameni.
And God will not be deceived by man.
Și Dumnezeu e milos, așa cum spun americanii.
God is merciful, as the American brothers say, and he is forgiving.
Dar mai spune că Dumnezeu este un foc mistuitor.
But the Bible also says that God's an all-consuming fire.
Și grozav lucru să cază în mâinile Dumnezeu.
And that it is a terrible thing to fall into the hands of the living God. We read out of Revelation chapter 7, beginning with verse 9. And it says, after these things I looked, and behold, a great multitude which no one could number, of all nations, tribes, peoples, and tongues, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes, with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, saying, salvation belongs to our God, who sits on the throne and to the Lamb. And all the angels stood around the throne, and the elders, and the four living creatures, and fell on their faces before the throne and worshipped God, saying, amen, blessing and glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen. Then one of the elders answered, saying to me, who are these arrayed in white robes, and where did they come from? And I said to him, sir, you know. So he said to me, these are the ones who come out of the great tribulation, and washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore they are before the throne of God and serve him day and night in his temple. And he who sits on the throne will dwell among them. They shall neither hunger any more nor thirst any more. The sun shall not strike them nor any heat. For the Lamb who is in the midst of the throne will shepherd them and lead them to living fountains of waters. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Amen. Amen.
Fraților, deci că am văzut un număr foarte mare.
Brothers, it says, I saw a great number.
Era din orice neam,
of all nations,
din orice seminții,
of all tribes,
și din orice popor,
and of all tongues.
Era și americani, români, ruși, chinezi și toți.
There were Americans, Romanians, Russians, Chinese, everybody.
Toți.
Everybody.
Erau îmbrăcați în haine albe.
And they were all dressed in white robes.
Și stăteau în fața scaunului domnii.
Standing before the throne of God.
Și unul din bătrâni o întreba.
And one of the elders posed the question.
Aceștia îmbrăcați în haine albe.
Who are these in white robes? And where did they come from?
Și le-a dat un răspuns frumos.
And an answer was given.
Aceștia vin din necazul cel mare de pe pământ.
These come out of the great tribulation on earth.
Ei și-au spălat hainele în sângele meu.
They've cleansed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore they are before the throne of God. There will be no more hunger there. No more thirst. No more cancer. Only eternal joy.
Amen.
Dacă vrei să ai parte de
această bucurie,
brother, if you want to be part of this joy,
aruncă tot răul din inima ta.
Strip off of the old self.
Aruncă idolii.
Throw away all your idols.
Aruncați vrăjitoriile.
Throw away all your witchcraft.
Dumnezeu nu-i vrăjitor.
Because God is not a witch.
Dar Dumnezeu îi da și amin.
What God says is yes and amen.
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 Dumnezeu să vă binecuvinteze.
Brothers, may God bless you.
Acum caut să încep să spun testimoniu.
Now I'll start telling you my testimony.
O să aveți răbdare.
I hope you're patient.
Chiar dacă am să țin prea mult seara asta.
Even if I speak a little longer tonight.
O să vă saturați.
Maybe next time you won't want to see me.
Eu m-am născut într-o familie de creștini.
I was born in a Christian family.
Tata meu a fost pastor la o biserică pentecostală.
And my dad pastored a Pentecostal church.
Eu la vârsta de 17 ani am fugit de acasă.
When I turned 17, I ran away from home.
M-am dus la școala militară din marină.
I went into Marine school.
Am făcut 4 ani jumate în școala militară.
I stayed for 4.5 years.
Am ieșit ofițer de marină.
And I became an officer.
Ne-au dat 80 de oameni în primire.
They gave me 80 new recruits.
M-au băgat pe Marea Neagră.
And they shipped me out on the Black Sea.
Ne-au dat ordin guvernul comunist.
The communist government gave me an order.
Să controlez vapoarele care vin din străinătate.
To check the ships that came in from foreign countries.
Dacă am să găsesc Biblie.
If I'd find Bibles.
Să confisc Biblie, să arestez pe misionari.
I was to confiscate the Bibles and arrest the missionaries.
Și repede să mă avansez.
And then I would be advanced quickly.
Când am auzit că problema să ajung o mare.
When I heard I was able to advance.
M-am apucat puternic de controla vapoarele.
I began checking the ships.
Și într-o dimineață a venit un vas din Olanda.
One morning a ship from Holland came
am
in.
Am intrat cu 8 oameni în control.
And I walked in with 8 of my men.
Și sub niște lăzi de biscuiți.
Under some crates of cookies.
Am găsit o cantitate mare de Biblie.
I found very many Bibles.
Am chemat pe șeful vasului.
I called the captain of the ship.
Și l-am întrebat, a cui sunt Biblia?
And I asked him, whose Bibles are these?
Au zis că nu știe.
He said he didn't know.
Dar într-o parte era un bărbat.
But when I looked to one side, there was this man
plângea și se ruga lui Dumnezeu,
who was crying and praying to God.
Eu când l-am văzut că el plânge,
when I saw that he was crying,
zic, lui trebuie să fie Biblia.
I said, the Bibles are his for sure.
Mă duc la el și spun, dă-mi pașaportul, te
rog. So I went to him and asked for his passport.
I-a scos pașaportul din buzunar.
He took his passport out of his pocket.
Era un misionar din Olanda care lucra cu Open Door.
He was a missionary from Holland who worked with Open Door's mission.
L-am întrebat, a tale Biblia?
So I asked him, are these your Bibles, sir?
Zice, no.
He said, no.
Da, cui sunt?
Whose are they then?
A fraților tăi și a surorii tale.
They belong to your brothers and your sisters, he said.
Când a zis așa, parcă mi-a dat cu cuțitul în inimă.
When he said this, I felt as though a knife went through my heart.
Am auzit o voce care ne-a vorbit în ureche.
And I began to hear a voice in my ear.
Ce faci tu, măi, Dimitri?
What are you doing, Dimitru?
Știi că eu te-am adus aici?
Don't you know that I brought you here?
Nu faci niciun rău la omul
ăsta. Do nothing to this man.
Pune niște soldați să-l păzească din poliție.
Tell some men to protect him from the police.
Dă-i pașaportul, că dacă nu aspru, te
give him his passport back. If he won't, I'll punish you harshly.
Când m-a lovit,
when he said he'd punish me,
m-am uitat la spate să văd cine-mi vorbea.
I turned around to see who had the courage to speak to me this way. But there was no one there. When I saw there was no one there, I began to shake. Who's speaking to me? What does this mean? I was embarrassed. I shook before the missionary. So I went into another compartment. And I stuck my fingers into my ears that I wouldn't hear the voice anymore. But it got even louder. Go, give him his passport. Tell some men to protect him from the police. Brothers, as I gave him the passport, the voice stopped. And I felt a new peace in my heart. I was on the Black Sea for 2.5 years. Many missionaries came through. And I would help everyone unload their Bibles. After 2.5 years, the communist government gave an order. All Christian children, no matter what rank, must go home. I had to go home. I was very sad. I'd lost my job. And so I went with thoughts of taking revenge on my parents. When I got home, my mom asked me, what's wrong with you, son? Why are you so sad? Because you're Christians, they kicked me out of the army. Where's dad? He's in church. Then I'll go embarrass him there, I said. She said, wait, you'll be home soon. But I said, no, I'm going there. When I got to the church, they were singing such a beautiful song. I'll never forget it. I'll tell you a verse of it also. Long ago, he came from above. The good shepherd, Jesus Christ. And he traveled throughout the world. He was looking for lost sheep. When he mentioned lost sheep, I began to cry but didn't want to cry. I thought, I'm the lost sheep. I ran away from home because my dad took me to church. And now Christ found me on the Black Sea. And now he's brought me back. I wet about 3 handkerchiefs, brothers. I kept looking around to see if anyone else was crying. Only my dad was, because he was happy he saw me in church. So I walked to my dad and asked him, Dad, why am I crying? He said, I'll tell you at the end of the service. At the end, he asked me to stand. And he said, Dimitru, are you sorry they kicked you out of the army? I said, yes, I am. Then he said, look, brothers, the answer to our prayers. For 2 years, we've been praying that he be kicked out. Then he said, God needs officers in his army also. Son, now you have to come to God. I said, okay, Dad, but let me get married first. He said, you can marry a girl from our church.
Well,
I can't from here, they're all poor. He said, go find a rich one, just come to God. I went and I found Maria.
Maria era orfană, fraților.
Maria was an orphan, brothers.
Dar ne-a spus că se pocăiește.
But she promised me that she'd come to God.
Oh, zic, dacă te pocăiești, eu te iau.
And I said, well, if you come to God, then I'll marry you.
Am luat-o pe Maria, m-am dus la adunare.
I married Maria, we began going to church.
Am încheiat legământ cu Dumnezeu.
We committed ourselves to God. Then we had to pray for 3 months. We fasted and we prayed.
Până am primit puterea de la Rusalii.
Until we received the power of God.
După ce am primit această putere,
after receiving this power,
am început să mergem prin biserici.
I began traveling through the churches.
Dar vă merg văzând că n-au Biblie oamenii.
I began to see the brothers had no Bibles.
Ce n-aveți voi Biblie?
So I began to ask, why don't you have any Bibles?
Eu când eram pe Marea Neagră, tare multe Biblie.
While I was on the Black Sea, many Bibles came in.
Da, frate Dumitru, zice, da, Bibliile au intrat pe mâna comunistilor.
They said, yes, brother Dumitru, but the Bibles came in through communist hands.
Comuniștii ni le-au vândut nouă.
The communists sold them to us.
Și a doua zi au trimis poliția și le-au confiscat.
And the next day they sent the police to confiscate them.
Și noi am rămas tot fără Biblie.
And we're still left without Bibles.
Când am auzit așa, mă frământam cu mintea acum să mă întâlnesc cu misiunea.
When I heard this, I began to think of how I could meet the missionaries.
Misionarii nu ne-au dat adresa niciodată.
Because missionaries would never leave their address.
M-am înțeles cu familia.
So I spoke to my family.
Am plecat din nou la port la Marea Neagră.
And again, I went to the Black Sea.
M-am dus la comandantul portului.
I went to the chief of the shipyard.
Să trăiesc, domn comandant.
I said, long live my chief.
Bună, băi, Dumitru, ce cu tine?
Hello, Dumitru, what are you doing here?
Domn comandant.
Well, chief.
M-am căsătorit și n-am servici.
I've gotten married and I have no job.
Dă-mi un servici aici.
Give me a job here.
Bă, pentru creștini n-am servici.
Look, I have no jobs for Christians.
Dar ce să fac, domn comandant, că eu n-am făcut decât școala militară.
Then what do I do, sir? I came here to Marine school.
Pe mine nu mă interesează.
No, I don't care.
E ordinul partidului, nu te pot primi.
Government orders, I can't go over them.
Domnul comandant, primește-mă măturător în port.
Chief, let me be a trash cleaner around here if nothing else.
Nu te pot vedea la mătură.
And I couldn't see you with a broom in your hand.
Ce să fac, domnule?
Then what do I do?
Bă, ia stai un pic.
He said, hold on a minute.
Tu te pricepi să faci mâncare?
Do you know how to cook?
Da, știu.
Oh, yes, I do.
Oh, merg bucătar la popota ofițerească.
Then go cook for the officers.
Și am să te plătesc foarte bine.
And I'll pay you very well.
Acolo trebuie să ajung.
That's where I had to be.
Că de acolo am putut să aud când vine vapoarele din străinătate.
That's when I'd hear them talking about when ships would come in.
Și am stat 3 luni de zile bucătar.
And so I cooked for 3 months.
Acolo m-am învățat să răb, frate.
That's where I learned how to suffer, brothers.
Pe cei ce comandam.
Those I had commanded before.
Acum aș bătea joc de mine.
Would not make fun of me.
Dar eu spuneam, rabdă, Dumitru.
But I'd say, suffer, Dumitru.
Hristos a răbdat mai mult.
Christ suffered much more.
După 3 luni de zile.
After 3 months.
Am auzit aceeași voce din vapor.
I heard the same voices from the ship.
Dumitru, fugi la bordul vaporului că vine dig.
Dumitru, run to the pier, dig is coming.
Am lăsat bucătăria și am fugit la bordul
vaporului. I left the kitchen and ran to the pier.
Când am ajuns acolo, fraților.
When I got there, brothers.
Primul om care ieșit din vapor a fost fratele Dig.
The first man to get off the ship was brother Dig.
Noi de departe am zis, pacea Domnului, frate Dig.
From afar I said, peace of God unto you, brother Dig.
Când m-a văzut civil, a început a plânge.
When he saw me in civilian clothing, he began to cry. He didn't know what had happened to me.
Deci ne întâlnim la hotelul 2 Constanța.
So he said, let's meet in the second hotel in Constanța.
Pentru că noi în România nu puteți fi stat de vorbă cu străini.
Romanians back then were not allowed to speak to foreigners.
Dacă mă prindeam, dădea 6 luni închisoare.
If I was caught, I'd have 6 months of jail.
Și a trebuit să mergem la hotel.
And so I went to the hotel.
Acolo ne-am rugat împreună.
There we prayed together.
Și împreună am plecat la București.
And together we left for Bucharest.
București e capitala României.
Bucharest is the capital of Romania.
Acolo l-am găsit pe fratele Andruș.
That's where we found brother Andrew.
Fratele Haralan Popov.
Brother Haralan Popov.
Fratele Wurmbrand.
Brother Wurmbrand.
Și alți frați.
And other brothers.
Care am făcut o legătură strânsă.
We made a strong pact.
Ei să aducă Bibliile în România.
They would bring the Bibles into Romania.
Și eu să le dau la biserică.
And I would give them to the churches.
Într-o perioadă de 3 ani, frate.
And within about 3 years, brothers. The majority of the churches had Bibles. It didn't matter what denomination they were. Because, brother, the denomination won't save you. It is your life lived with God. Men created the names. He's a Baptist, he's a Pentecostal, he's a non-denominational. And they try to divide Christ whichever way they want. But there's only one faith. There's only one God. And there's only one baptism.
Noi trebuie să înțelegem, fraților.
We must understand this, brothers.
Acum în vremurile noastre,
especially
în America.
The times that we live in, and especially in America.
Nu-i place botezul numele Tatălui, a Fiului și a Sfântului Duh.
Now I've heard that the baptism in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit is no longer permitted.
No, că n-a fost bun aceasta.
Some people don't like it anymore.
Că Petru a zis să te boteze în numele lui Hristos.
Because Peter said that you should be baptized in the name of Christ.
Fraților.
Brothers.
De cine credeți mai mult, pe Hristos sau pe Petru?
If it comes down to it, who should we trust more, Christ or Peter?
Vreau răspuns.
Answer, please.
Hristos spune în Matei.
And Jesus Christ says in Matthew.
Mergeți în toată lumea.
Go ye into all the world.
Faceți ucenici din toate neamurile.
Make disciples of all men.
Botezându-i în numele Tatălui.
Baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Motivul că a zis Petru în numele lui Isus.
The reason Peter said baptize in the name of Jesus.
Apostolul i-a spus lui Petru arată-ne pe Tatăl și ne este de ajuns.
Is because an apostle once said show us the Father and it will be enough.
Și atunci Isus le-a spus lor.
And then Jesus answered.
De atâta vreme sunt cu voi.
I have been with you for such a long time.
Și vreau să-l vedeți pe Tatăl.
And you want to see the Father?
Eu sunt în Tatăl.
I am within the Father.
Tatăl este în mine.
And the Father is within me.
Și eu sunt în voi.
And I am within you.
Și acum un cuvânt greșit.
And that gave the understanding.
Îl luăm de bună.
And because he said one word, then
ca
we have to twist everything around.
Să luăm alte botezuri.
And it's just another thing that'll make us become not aware.
Și un singur botez.
Because there is only one baptism, brothers.
Dacă te-au botezat când erai mic.
If you were baptized when you were a baby.
Acela nu-i botez, că tu nu știi.
That doesn't count because you were not aware of it.
Dar dacă te-au botezat când ești un mare.
But if you were baptized as an adult.
Și tu ai crezut.
And you believed.
Nu te mai boteza o dată.
Don't get baptized again.
Că faci păcat.
Because then it is a sin.
Amen.
Amen.
Ați tăcut, vă că.
Ooh, you're quiet.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Așa, băi, fraților.
Better brothers. We have to be awake.
Nu vă întristați de un cuvânt drept.
Don't be sad because it is the truth.
Eu vă dau scris.
It's scriptural.
Și nu vorbesc de la mine.
These are not my words.
Dacă așa spune în Biblia mea românească.
If this is what my Romanian Bible says.
O să o fac ca americanilor, nu.
Can I twist it around to make it an American Bible? No, I can't.
Americanii mai schimbă Biblia.
Because I know Americans like changing the Bible around a lot.
Mormonii o face să-i placă lor.
The Mormons make it towards their own way of thinking. The Jehovah's Witnesses towards their own way of thinking. There's over 2,000 active denominations in this country. You don't know what to believe. And there's a word in the Bible. From the rushing of the rivers. Many will not know what to believe. The rivers are all the things that we hear and all the people in the world. But brothers, know that you have the Bible in your hand. And this is the greatest prophet. Don't change it.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, can you get a glass of water, please? A început la când s-a zis să fii bucătar.
Am vorbit acolo.
Da.
Într-o perioadă de 3 ani de zile, fraților, majoritatea bisericilor au primit Biblia.
As I said, brothers, in about 3 years, most of the churches had Bibles.
Când a aflat guvernul comunist, voi spuneți să nu-i aducă de la WCO. Spuneți să nu-i aducă de la WCO.
Nu, aduce-i acum. Let's go. That's how the chop. All right.
Nu de la bathroom.
Not bathroom water, though.
Când a aflat guvernul comunist că a intrat Biblia în țară,
when the communist government found out Bibles were coming into the country, they shut the borders. And then no more foreigners come in. But the churches continued to pray to God so that God would send them Bibles. God heard the prayers of the church. And he sent an intense rain over Romania. In 1970, over half the country was flooded. When the communists saw this, they asked for the foreigners' help. They reopened the borders. And Bibles started coming in freely. For 4 years, Bibles came in freely. No one checked them at the border anymore. Because that's how God works. If you trust in God, God will not let you down. In these 4 years, brothers, they ran out of Romanian Bibles. So they began to bring in very many Russian Bibles. I live 18 kilometers away from the Russian border. I tried to take them over, but I couldn't. And so I hid a lot of Bibles everywhere. The police began to follow me. And if they'd found out that you were taking Bibles in, or that you had contacts with foreigners, you have 25 years of prison and the confiscation of all material wealth. And so I came home very sad. When my dad saw my face so pale, he asked, Dimitru, are you sick? I said, no, dad.
Then what's zic, tata, am atâtea Biblii
ruse. I said, Dad, I have so many Russian Bibles.
Am vrut să le trec dincolo,
I keep trying to take them across the border, but I can't. And now the police is following me.
Băi, vrut tu?
You wanted to.
Zic, da, eu.
I said, yeah, me.
Băi, tu te-ai rugat?
Did you pray first?
Zic, nu.
No.
Băi, tu ai postit?
Did you fast?
Zic, nu.
No.
Ai întrebat de Domnul?
Did you ask God about this?
Nu.
Well, no.
De ce n-ai dus, băi?
That's why you couldn't take him over.
Ia, hai, băi, să postim.
Let's fast.
Să ne rugăm.
Let's pray.
Și să vină Dumnezeu să-ți arate.
And God will come and show you a way.
Asta a fost hotărârea ca seara asta.
We had that conversation in the evening.
Și mâine seară.
And the next night.
Nu eram bine adormit.
I wasn't fully asleep.
Și odată am auzit o voce, scoală, Dumitru.
And I heard a voice, get up, Dimitru.
Am sărit drept în picioare.
I jumped up.
La capul patului meu.
And at the head of my bed.
Era un om îmbrăcat într-o haină albă.
There was a man dressed in a white robe.
Eu când l-am văzut, m-am speriat.
When I saw him, I became scared.
Băi, zic, până eu intrat aici, că ușa era încuiată.
How did he get in? Because my door was still locked.
Geamurile închise.
Windows were all shut.
Dar el strigă la mine, Dumitru, nu te teme.
But he says to me, Dumitru, don't be afraid.
A venit să-ți spun pe unde să duci Biblia.
I came to tell you how to take your Bibles over. He told me the place where to go. Taught me what to say. And even how to get there. The place was a train station on the border. And I was supposed to go meet a man. While I was getting dressed, the man disappeared. And I ran to my dad's house. Dad, look what I just saw.
Băi, du-te, că noi ne sculam să ne rugăm.
He said, go, I'll wake up the others and we'll pray.
Și am ajuns dimineața la ora 8.
And I got there at 8 in the morning.
Acolo linia ferată la Rusia e mai lată ca la România.
The train tracks in Russia are wider than in Romania.
Acolo trebuie să schimbi osile la vagoane.
And that was the station where they changed all the axles.
În timp ce schimbau la un tren, în alt tren, trebuie să bagi Biblia.
And while they changed them on the train, we could have put the Bibles in.
Și m-am dus la șeful gării și am bătut la ușă.
I went to the chief and I knocked on the door.
El a ieșit tremurând.
The man came out shaking. But the angel had already told me, the man will ask you what you want. Tell him you were sent by the one who was just there. And then he'll teach you what to do. So when he came out shaking, I said, good morning, chief. He said, well, what do you want? I was sent by the one who was just here. And he started shaking even worse. Well, what do you want? I want to take Bibles into Russia. He called me inside. Taught me how to bring the Bibles. Where to put them. And how to load them into the train. And within about 15 years, we took over 300,000 Bibles into Russia. But not me. Not with my strength, but it was the hand of God directly.
Amen. Amen.
After 15 years, a missionary from Holland came to my home. And he said, Dimitru, I tried to go to Russia to see if the Bibles are getting there. The Russians wouldn't let me in. They kicked me out. Why don't you try to go over? Look, you know how to speak Russian anyway. You go. I went and I got a passport. And I went to Russia. When I got to Chișinău, the police was waiting for me. Everywhere I went, the police was after me. I came to Chișinău for nothing. I stayed for 4 days. I couldn't contact any of my people. They were always after me. So I said, maybe I'm going to go to Odessa. Maybe they won't know me there. I got off the train, and the police already came to say hi. Even more than in Chișinău. Man, what's with all these people?
Mă făceam că nu înțeleg nimic rusesc.
You know, I was trying to say that. I didn't understand how to speak Russian. And they try to find me a translator. And I tell them, I understand what they're saying. I just want to not let them know about it. Couldn't do anything in Odessa either. Couldn't speak to anyone there. So I ran to Kiev. Maybe they'll lose me in Kiev. When I got to Kiev, I got off the train, and a policeman grabbed me by the arm. Come on, we've been waiting for you for a while. They took me to my hotel. Leave unless you let us know first. I stayed in the hotel that day. And the next day I wanted to go out to the market. The police was still following me. I got very ill. And they took me and checked me into the hospital. A doctor came in. The syringe was one of those that you used to give to cows in the old days. He gave me a shot and it hurt worse than I'd ever dreamed it would. He says, now he'll sleep. Și l-am aranjat eu. I gave him a good one. Eu am înțeles ce au zis. I understood what they were saying. Și nu era bine ieșit din cameră. And the man just barely got out of the room. Eu am adormit. And I passed out. Am dormit până a doua zi dimineață. I slept until the next morning. A doua zi dimineață aud că bate cineva. The next morning I heard somebody knocking on the door. Zic, cine e acolo? Who's there? Și doctorul. Doctor. Când am auzit că e doctor. When I heard the word doctor. Nu m-a mai durut. Nothing hurt anymore anyway. I didn't even know I was ill. Am zis că nu mai fac injecții. I said, but no matter what, I'm still not going to get another shot. Mă întreabă, ce faci, Dimitru? So he asks, how are you, Dimitru? Zic, bine. Oh, well. Băi, te mai doare? Do you still hurt? Zic, nu. No. Băi, să-ți mai fac voi injecții. You need another shot or something? Am zis, fă-ți ție, nu mai trebuie. Give one to yourself, I don't need it. Dar nu mai era doctorul cealaltă. But it wasn't the same doctor. Era altul. It was a different one. Îl trimite pe cel ce era cu trusa în mână. The doctor sends the nurse away. Și el intră în cameră și închide ușa. He walks into the room and he locks the door. Vine la mine, dă mâna cu mine. He walks to me and he hugs me. Mă prinde, zice, pacea Domnului, frate Dumitru. And he says, peace of God unto you, brother Dimitru. He said, an angel of the Lord came into my dream last night. And he showed me in a dream.
Unde ești tu?
That you were here.
Și să vin să te scot de aici.
And I was supposed to come and get you out.
Eu îți fac foaie de internare.
I'll draw up some papers that you'll be checked in.
O foaie să o dau la poliție, că stă poliția la ușă.
I'll give a paper to the policeman who's waiting outside.
Și una o las la birou.
And I'll leave one with the office.
Și tu mergi cu mine.
And then I'll sneak you out the back.
Te scot prin spate și mergem.
And then we'll go.
Și așa s-a întâmplat, frate.
And that's exactly how it happened, brothers.
N-am mai intrat în spital.
I wasn't checked into the hospital.
Am umblat Kiev.
Instead, I traveled all of Kiev without the police following me.
Dumnezeu a trimis un pastor baptist.
God sent a Baptist pastor.
Și acela m-a scos de acolo.
And that's the man that got me out.
Dar mai mult ca atât, m-a dus și mi-a arătat cum a ajuns Biblia.
In our travels, he also showed me how the Bibles were getting there.
Și am avut o mare bucurie.
And for me, it was a great joy.
Dar când m-am întors de la Kiev,
but when I got home from Kiev,
casa mea era înconjurată de poliție.
My house was surrounded by the police.
Înăuntru nevasta o ținea cu fața la perete.
They were holding my wife with her face against the wall.
Pe mine m-a legat și m-a pus cu fața la perete.
They tied me and put me with my face against the wall.
Și a început controlul dimineața la ora 8.
They began checking the house at 8 in the morning.
Și a terminat după masă la ora 4.
And they finished at 4 in the evening.
Au venit cu tot felul de aparate.
They came with all kinds of equipment.
Căuta Biblie.
They were looking for Bibles.
Am avut foarte multe Biblie.
I had very many Bibles at my house.
La ora 4 vine un colonel la mine.
But at 4 a colonel comes to me.
Și mă întreabă, "Oi, Dumitru, întoarce-te."
And he says, "Dimitri, turn around, please.
Unde tu unii ai Biblie?
Where do you have your Bibles at?"
Eu am crezut că le-au găsit.
You know, I honestly thought they'd found them.
Le-ați găsit?
Did you find them?
Zice, nu.
Well, no.
Dacă nu le-ați găsit, înseamnă că nu am.
If you didn't find them, I don't have them, I said.
Da, unde ai depozitul de Biblie?
They said, "Yeah, but where'd you hide all those Bibles at?"
Eu n-am fabrică de Biblie, domnule.
What Bibles? I don't have a Bible press, sir.
Lasă că să spui tu și ce ai mâncat când erai mic.
Don't worry, you'll tell us what you ate when you were a child even.
M-a pus în mașină și m-a dus la.
They put me in the car and took me to the police station.
Acolo a început torturile.
And that's where the tortures began.
Prima dată m-au pus să dau declarații.
First they asked me to confess.
Să spun de unde am Bibliile.
Tell them where I had the Bibles from.
Pe unde le-am trecut la Rusia.
How I got them into Russia.
Și cine m-a ajutat să le
duc. And who helped me take them there.
Dar în urechea mea suna aceeași voce.
But in my ear, there was still that same voice from the ship.
Dimitru, să nu spui.
Dimitru, don't tell.
Dimitru, să nu recunoști.
Dimitru, don't confess.
Dimitru, eu sunt cu tine.
Dimitru, I am with you.
Eu am să te izbăvesc.
I will save you.
N-am spus nimic.
I said nothing.
Au văzut că nu spun nimic.
They saw I wasn't saying anything.
M-au luat și m-au dus într-o cameră foarte întunecoasă.
They took me and threw me into a very dark room.
Așa întuneric era că nu vedeam pereți.
It was so dark that I couldn't see the walls even.
Deci aici stai până să spui.
You'll be here until you confess.
Au închis ușa și au plecat.
They locked the door and took off.
La o bucată de timp aud că trage cineva un obor.
After a while, I heard somebody open another door.
Băi, zic, ce capcană au ăștia?
I began to think, what sort of traps could they have in here?
Dar aud un țâmpit de șobolan.
But then I began to hear a squeak, like a rat squeak.
Băi, zic, ce animale au?
And what sort of animals could they have in here?
Simt că urcă pe mine.
And then I felt it crawl up my leg.
Când am pus mâna,
when I touched it, it was a rat about this big.
Dar dam unul, doi și poate 10 să urcă.
I'd take one or two off, maybe 10 or crawl back on.
Așa de tare m-am speriat.
I was so terrified.
Am zberat cât am putut.
That I yelled as loud as I could.
Doamne, nu m-a lăsat.
God, don't let me down.
Era strigat așa, s-a aprins o lumină puternică.
When I said this, an intense light appeared in the room.
De lumină am auzit o voce.
And out of the light I heard a voice.
Dimitru, nu te teme.
Dimitru, don't be afraid.
Dimitru, uite-te la mine.
Dimitru, look at me.
Când am ridicat capul să mă uit.
When I raised my head to look.
Așa puternic a fost lumina.
The light was so powerful.
Că am căzut cu fața la pământ.
That it threw me on the ground.
Și ți-am spus să te uiți la
mine. He said, I told you to look at me.
Cine ești tu?
I said, who are you?
Eu sunt îngerul Gabriel.
I am the angel Gabriel.
Sunt mesagerul cerului.
I am the messenger of heaven.
M-ai chemat, am venit în ajutorul
tău. I have come to help you.
Deci nu te teme.
Don't be afraid. You will go through many trials.
Dar te scot din mâna lor și te duc în America.
But I'll take you out of their hands and take you into America.
Ia uite-te tu în jos.
Look down, he said.
Când m-am uitat în jos,
when I looked down,
șobolanii erau morți la pământ.
The whole floor was covered with dead rats.
În timpul ce alea a dispărut lumina.
At that time, the light disappeared.
Eu mai tare m-am speriat.
And I became even more terrified.
Deodată să mă mănânce șobolanii.
And they intended these rats to eat me.
Deodată a venit un polițar, a deschis ușa.
A policeman came and opened the door.
M-a întrebat, tu mai trăiești?
And he asked, still alive in there?
Zic, da, m-ați dat să mă mănânce șobolanii.
I said, yeah, did you try to have me dinner for the rats?
Atunci a venit, nu știu cu ce m-a lovit în cap.
The man came and he hit me over the head.
Că eu am căzut jos.
I fell down.
M-a tras de picioare afară.
He pulled me out by the feet.
Și m-a dus în altă cameră.
And took me into another room.
M-a legat de la mijloc.
Tied me by the waist, pulled me up on a pulley, and with rubber hoses they beat my feet. They throw water on me, and after I'd get better, they'd ask me to confess. They'd lay me face flat, put a board over me, and 5 or 6 until blood would come out my nose and my mouth. Again, they throw water on me, and again ask me to confess. They'd stick my hand in the door and poke me with pins under my fingernails. For 5 months, they did all sorts of experiments. But in my ear, there was always that voice. Dimitru, don't tell. Dimitru, don't confess. Dimitru, I am with you. After 5 months of torture, they took me to a room. And there they had a very strange-looking chair. Do you see this chair? Yes, I do. Well, we brought this from Germany, especially for you. Tell us or you'll die on it. Even if I die, I have nothing to tell you. They tied my hands on the chair. They tied my feet around it. They put a bowl on my head. Plugged 2 things in my ears. Now think what you've done. You're about to die. And when they turned it on, brothers, I felt such an intense shock. I couldn't feel my tongue in my mouth anymore. I couldn't see with my eyes anymore either. And when I thought I'm about to die, again the same light appeared. It was the same man. Dimitru, don't be afraid. Dimitru, you will not die. Plead the blood of Jesus. And I began to say, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. I don't know how long I said it for. When I woke up, I was covered with blood. And they were throwing water on me. Do you know that you've confessed? Listen to yourself. Our equipment recorded everything you said. And when they turned it on, I heard my voice. The blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus was victorious. Not I, but it was Jesus.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Why do you sleep? If I see you sleeping, you know I yell hallelujah.
După a doua zi l-au adus-o pe Maria.
The next day they brought in Maria.
Maria, tu vrei să-i dau drumul lui Dumitru?
Maria, would you like us to let Dimitru go?
Și da, cum să nu vreau?
Oh, yes, of course I do.
Maria, Dumitru a spus tot.
Well, Maria, Dimitru's confessed.
A spus unde are Bibliile.
He told us where he has his Bibles.
A spus cine i-a adus Bibliile.
Told us who brought him the Bibles.
Cum le-a trecut la ruși.
How he got them to Russia.
Și cine le-a ajutat să le treacă.
And even who helped him take them.
Scrie aici tu.
You write it down here also.
Și dăm drumul lui Dumitru.
And we'll let Dimitru go.
Dumnezeu nu a lăsat-o pe Maria.
But God wouldn't let Maria tell.
Dacă știe Dumitru, a spus el, știe el, dar eu nu știu.
If Dimitru told you, he knows, but I know nothing about it.
Atunci i-a chemat, a sărit la dânsa și a luat-o la bataie.
Then they began to hit her.
Yes, a speriat.
She became scared and she fainted.
O pus în mașină și o dus acasă.
They put her in the car and they took her home.
O veni la mine.
And then they came to me.
Dumitru, tu ai auzit că a fost.
Did you hear your wife was just here?
Da, m-a auzit că ați bătut-o.
I said, yeah, I heard how you beat her.
Bă, eu a spus tot și am dus-o acasă.
Well, she told us everything and we took her home.
Spune și tu și te duc și pe tine.
You tell us too, we'll take you home also.
Dacă a spus ea știe, dar eu nu știu.
Well, if she told you, she knows, but I know nothing about it.
Oh, ați fost sfătuiți.
And they said, oh, you had all this planned out.
Din nou m-a pus pe scaune.
And again, they put me on the chair.
De data asta te ard, bă.
This time I'll fry you.
Au făcut același lucru cu mine.
They did the same thing to me.
Și când credeam că gata, mor.
And when I thought this time I surely die.
Iar a venit îngerul Domnului.
Again the angel of God came.
Dimitru, nu te teme.
Dimitru, don't be afraid.
Eu sunt cu tine.
I am with you.
Mai de trecut printr-o încercare și să te scot din mâna.
You'll go through one more trial and I'll take out of their hands.
Vrăjmașul tău va muri, dar tu vei trăi.
Your enemy will die, but you will live.
Strigă sângele lui Isus.
Plead the blood of Jesus.
Iar am strigat sângele lui.
And again I began.
Când m-am trezit la fel.
When I woke up, I woke up the same way.
O dat drumul la aparate.
They turned on their equipment.
De data asta tot ai spus.
You know this time you've confessed, don't you?
Și când o dat drumul iar sângele lui Isus, sângele lui Isus.
And when they turned it on again, I heard the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus.
De ce ai zis asta?
Why'd you say this?
Pentru că vrei să mă omori.
Because you want to kill me.
Băi, tot te omor.
We'll still kill you.
Pus mâna pe telefon.
The colonel took up the phone.
O chema 6 polițiști.
And he called up 6 policemen.
O strigați, omorâți-l, băi.
All I heard was, kill him.
Sări cu picioarele pe mine.
They jumped on me with their boots.
Am avut 5 coaste rupte.
I had 9 ribs broken.
Am căzut în comă.
I fell into a coma.
Cât am stat în comă, nu știu.
I don't know how long I was in a coma for.
Eu când m-am trezit, un doctor îmi face injecție în mâna dreaptă.
But when I woke up, a doctor was giving me a shot in the right arm.
Și mă ștergea cu o batistă pe obraz.
And he was wiping my face with a handkerchief.
Spunea, măi, Dumitru, măi.
And he kept saying, Dimitru, your God still let you live.
În timpul acela a venit un alt ofițer.
At that time, an officer ran in. And he began to yell.
Hai, domn doctor, că moare colonelul.
Hurry, doctor, the colonel, he's dying.
Doctorul a fugit după dânsul.
The doctor ran after the officer.
Și eu așteptam să vedem ce se întâmplă.
And I was waiting to see what was going on.
A venit un alt colonel.
Another colonel came to me.
Și mă întreabă cu o voce blândă.
And with a humble voice, he asks,
Dimitru, ce faci?
Dimitru, how are you?
De ce mă întreb?
Why do you ask?
Tu poți să te îmbraci?
Can you get dressed?
De ce să mă îmbrac?
Why should I?
Mergi acasă.
You're going home.
Că da, ați terminat de omorât.
So you finished killing me already.
Băi, Dumnezeu tău ți-a făcut dreptate.
They said, your God's given you justice.
Colonelul Prestenuc a murit.
Colonel Prestenuc's dead.
Și comandantul a dat ordine să te duc repede acasă.
And the chief ordered that I take you home quickly.
Dar cum a murit, domnule?
How did he die?
Deci a dat o imoragie internă.
He had an internal hemorrhage.
Era cu dosarul tău.
While he was going through your papers.
A căzut jos și a murit.
He fell down and died.
Comandantul a zis să te duc repede acasă.
And the chief said to take you home quickly.
Să nu te rogi la Dumnezeu tău să mă pedepsească și pe mine.
Then he said, don't pray to your God that he punish me too.
Eu nu ți-am făcut niciun rău.
Because you know I never did anything to you.
O mai chemat un ofițer.
He called another officer.
M-a îmbrăcat și m-a dus acasă.
They dressed me and they took me home.
Când am ajuns acasă, fraților, nu mă cunoștea nici nevastă.
Brothers, when I got home, my own wife didn't recognize me anymore.
Eram complet distrus.
I've been completely destroyed.
Nu puteam să stau nici în picioare,
I couldn't stand up. I couldn't lie down on either side.
Nevasta mea a făcut un pat cu perni.
So my wife filled a bed with pillows.
Frații m-au luat pe mână și m-au pus între perni.
The brothers took me in their arms and they put me in the pillows.
Acolo am stat 3 luni de zile.
And that's where I stayed for 3 months.
Acolo am chemat moartea.
That's where I called death to come.
Așa o suferință am avut.
I couldn't stand the suffering anymore.
Mirosea carnea pe mine.
My flesh began to smell on my own body.
N-am mai zis că mai scap.
I never thought I'd survive it.
Dar când credeam că nu mai am nicio putere.
But when I thought I had no more hope.
La spital nu m-au putut duce.
They couldn't take me to the hospital.
Primul răspuns un fost coleg al meu zice, nu-l duce pe Dumitru la spital.
A friend of mine sent a letter, don't take Dumitru to the hospital. They want to give him a shot and kill him.
Și Maria a zis că lasă-l să stea în patul lui.
So Maria said if he dies, he dies in his bed.
Dacă vrea Dumnezeu să-l ia, să-l ia și de aici și de acolo.
If God wants to take him home, he'll take him home either way.
Dar era noaptea târziu.
It was very late at night.
Nu mai puteam sta eu de mirosul care era acasă.
I couldn't stand the smell of my flesh any longer.
Și deodată s-a aprins o lumină în cameră.
And all of a sudden the light appeared in my room.
Din lumina aceeași voce.
And out of the light I heard the same voice.
Dumitru, de ajuns, ești afară.
Dimitri, enough. Get out.
Am sărit din pat.
I jumped out of bed.
Am fugit afară.
I ran outside.
Mă căutam să văd dacă mă mai doare.
I kept feeling myself to see if I still hurt.
Nu mă durea.
Nothing hurt anymore.
Puteam să merg.
I was able to walk.
Ce s-a întâmplat cu mine?
What's happening to me?
Am visat. Am visat, e realitate.
Am I dreaming? Is this actually true?
Și m-am turnat înapoi.
I walked back into the house.
M-am turnat înapoi.
When I went in,
am găsit pe îngerul Domnului.
I found the angel of God.
M-a întrebat, Dimitru, te mai doare?
Dimitru, do you still hurt?
Zic, nu.
No.
Poți să mergi?
Can you walk?
Zic, da, pot.
Yes, I can.
Maria, Dimitru a spus tot.
Well, Maria, Dimitru's confessed.
A spus unde are Bibliile.
He told us where he has his Bibles.
A spus cine i-a adus Bibliile.
Told us who brought him the Bibles.
Cum le-a trecut la ruși.
How he got them to Russia.
Cine i-a ajutat să le treacă.
And even who helped him take them.
Scrie aici tu.
You write it down here also.
Și dăm drumul lui Dimitru.
And we'll let Dimitru go.
Dumnezeu nu a lăsat-o pe Maria.
But God wouldn't let Maria tell.
Ce dacă știe Dumitru, a spus el, știe el, dar eu nu știu.
If Dimitru told you, he knows, but I know nothing about it.
Atunci eu chemat, sărit la dânsa și-o luat-o la bataie.
Then they began to hit her. She became scared and she fainted. They put her in the car and they took her home. And then they came to me. Dimitru, did you hear your wife was just here? I said, yeah, I heard how you beat her. Well, she told us everything and we took her home. You tell us too, we'll take you home also. Well, if she told you, she knows, but I know nothing about it. And they said, oh, you had all this planned out. And again, they put me on the chair. This time, I'll fry you. They did the same thing to me. And when I thought this time I'd surely die, again the angel of God came. Dimitru, don't be afraid. I am with you. You'll go through one more trial and I'll take you out of their hands. Your enemy will die, but you will live. Plead the blood of Jesus. And again I began. When I woke up, I woke up the same way. They turned on their equipment.
And
you know, this time you've confessed, don't you? And when they turned it on, again I heard, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. Why'd you say this? Because you want to kill me. We'll still kill you. The colonel took up the phone, and he called up 6 policemen. All I heard was, kill him. They jumped on me with their boots. I had 9 ribs broken. I fell into a coma. I don't know how long I was in a coma for. But when I woke up, a doctor was giving me a shot in the right arm. And he was wiping my face with a handkerchief. And he kept saying, Dimitru, your God still let you live. At that time, an officer ran in. And he began to yell, hurry, doctor, the colonel, he's dying. The doctor ran after the officer. And I was waiting to see what was going on. Another colonel came to me. And with a humble voice, he asked, Dimitru, how are you? Why do you ask? Can you get dressed? Why should I? You're going home. So you finished killing me already. They said, your God's given you justice. Colonel Prestonuk's dead. And the chief ordered that I take you home quickly. How did he die? He had an internal hemorrhage while he was going through your papers. He fell down and died. And the chief said to take you home quickly. Then he said, don't pray to your God that he punish me too. Because you know I never did anything to you. He called another officer. They dressed me and they took me home. Brothers, when I got home, my own wife didn't recognize me anymore. I'd been completely destroyed. I couldn't stand up. I couldn't lie down on either side. So my wife filled a bed with pillows. The brothers took me in their arms and they put me in the pillows. And that's where I stayed for 3 months. That's where I called death to come. I couldn't stand the suffering anymore. My flesh began to smell on my own body. I never thought I'd survive it.
Dar când credeam că nu mai am nicio putere.
But when I thought I had no more hope,
la spital nu m-au putut duce.
They couldn't take me to the hospital.
Un fost coleg al meu zice, nu-l duce pe Dumitru la spital.
A friend of mine sent a letter, don't take Dumitru to the hospital. They want to give him a shot and kill him.
Și Maria a zis că lasă-l să stea în patul lui.
So Maria said, if he dies, he dies in his bed.
Dacă vrea Dumnezeu să-l ia, să-l ia și de aici și de acolo.
If God wants to take him home, he'll take him home either way.
Dar era noaptea târziu.
It was very late at night.
Nu mai puteam sta eu de mirosul care era
carne. I couldn't stand the smell of my flesh any longer.
Și deodată s-a aprins o lumină în cameră.
And all of a sudden, the light appeared in my room.
Din lumina aceeași voce.
And out of the light, I heard the same voice.
Dumitru, de ajuns, ești afară.
Dimitri, enough. Get out. I jumped out of bed. I ran outside. I kept feeling myself to see if I still hurt. Nothing hurt anymore. I was able to walk. What's happening to me? Am I dreaming? Is this actually true? I walked back into the house. When I went in, I found the angel of God. Dimitru, do you still hurt? No. Can you walk? Yes, I can. Then Dimitru, start working. You have 4 more years to carry Bibles in.
Poliția va fi pas cu pas.
The police
tine.
Will follow you step by step.
Dar eu voi fi lângă tine,
but I will be with you always.
Și voi închide ochii ca să nu te poată.
I will blind their eyes and they won't be able to catch you.
Fraților, și așa a fost.
Brothers, that's exactly how it
în
happened.
4 ani am cărat mai multe Biblie ca în 15
ani. In those 4 years I smuggled in more Bibles than the 15 years before that.
De două ori pe săptămână îmi făcea control.
Twice a week they come and check my house.
Oriunde mă duceam, mă oprea poliția.
Everywhere I went, the police would stop me.
Ce ai în mașină?
What do you have in the car?
Biblie.
Bibles.
Uite, bă, cine minte.
He's lying to us again.
Îți bați joc de noi.
Are you trying to make fun?
Deschide portbagajul.
Open the trunk.
Deschideam portbagajul.
I'd open the trunk.
Era tot Biblia împachetată.
The whole trunk was loaded down with Bibles.
Și unde bă, îți bați joc de mine, hai de drum.
They'd leave through him, he's making fun of us. Just go.
4 ani am făcut așa.
This lasts for 4 years.
Dar îngerul ne-a spus, fii atent aici.
But the angel said,
când se va împlini aceștia 4 ani.
When these 4 years will be over.
Zice, guvernul comunist te va scoate din casa ta.
The communist government will take you out of your home.
Din țara ta.
Out of your country.
Te va da afară.
And they'll kick you out.
Dar eu voi fi cu tine și acolo.
But I'll be with you even where you're going.
Ne-a spus anul, luna și ziua.
Brothers, he told me the year, the month, the day and even the hour.
Exact la aceeași oră.
And on that hour.
Am fost scos afară din țară.
I was kicked out of my country.
Și m-au dat în Italia.
I was taken to Italy.
Am stat o vreme în Italia.
I stayed in Italy for a while.
M-au trimis după mine în securitatea să mă omoare.
The secret service sent people to kill me there too.
Dar Dumnezeu a fost cu mine și în Italia.
But God was faithful even in Italy.
Și cu ajutorul lui Dumnezeu.
And with God's help.
Și ajutorul ambasadei americane din Italia.
And the help of the American embassy in Italy.
Am ajuns în Sodoma și Gomorra, frate.
I got to Sodom and Gomorrah, brothers.
În California.
I got to California.
Nu le dăm pauză?
Ba da.
Eu cred că să vă dăm o lea de pauză.
I believe this would be a good time to give you a break.
După care vom începe din nou să vă spunem testimoniul pentru America.
After which I will tell you what will come to America.
Din nou încep să vorbesc, fraților.
I will continue, brothers.
Dar parcă nu-mi convine așa bine să spun de mine și nu spun de Iisus.
But I never like speaking about myself. I always enjoy speaking about Jesus.
Amen.
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 Ar fi bine ca toți să ne întoarcem către Dumnezeu.
Because it is mandatory for all of us to have our lives right with God.
Dacă până acum.
If until now.
Am trăit cum am vrut noi.
We've lived the way we wanted to.
De acum să ne oprim.
Now the time has come when we must stop.
Ajunge că în trecut ați făcut voia neamurilor.
It's enough that in the past we did what the world asked us to.
Ați trăit în plăceri.
Some lived in wickedness.
În tot felul de lucruri.
Others in abominations.
Se pune în capăt.
We must put an end to all these things.
Să întornăm către Dumnezeu.
And return to God.
Ca în ziua nenorocirii.
So that in the day of trouble.
Dumnezeu să ne salveze.
God would save us.
Amen.
Amen.
Fraților, eu n-am venit să vă înspăimânt.
Brothers, I'm not here to scare you.
Eu am venit ca să vă îmbărbătez.
Instead, I've come to strengthen you.
Că de ochiul lui Dumnezeu noi nu putem să ne ascundem.
Because we should know no man can hide from the eye of God.
Dacă te duci în fundul mării,
if you go into the bottom of the ocean,
El e și acolo.
He will be there.
Te duci în inima pământului,
if you go into the heart of the earth,
El e și acolo.
He will be there also.
Și unde vrei să fugi de Dumnezeu?
So where can we run from God?
Numai să te ieși cu viața ta din lume.
Our only option is for our lives to be void of the world.
Ca să trăiești viața cum spune cuvântul lui Dumnezeu.
It is to live our lives as the word of God asks.
Amen.
Amen.
De acum încep să vă spun cine a arătat Dumnezeu pentru țara asta.
Now I will tell you what God showed me for this country.
Fraților, nu sunt basme.
Brothers, these are not fairy tales.
Este lucrurile și nu sunt vedenii cum zic unii.
And it is not a vision as some say.
Eu eram treaz cum să acum.
I was awake as I am now.
Când Dumnezeu mi-a arătat toate lucrurile.
When God showed me the things I'm about to tell you.
Când am venit în Sodoma și Gomorra.
When I got to Sodom and Gomorrah.
M-a luat o organizație Tolstoi rusească
de la aeroport. I was picked up by a Russian foundation named Tolstoi from the airport.
Și m-a dus într-un apartament care și acum.
And they took me to an apartment where we still live.
Apartamentul era foarte murdar.
Back then the apartment was very dirty.
N-avea furnituri, n-avea nimic.
There was no furniture, there was nothing inside.
Trăiesc niște câini acolo.
It seems dogs lived there before us.
Și carpetul mirosea foarte puternic.
And the carpet had a very strong odor.
Nu puteai intra în nuntă.
I couldn't even walk inside.
Cum intrai, începeai să vomiți.
When I'd walk in, I'd start to cough.
Și nevasta mea a început să plângă.
And my wife began to cry.
Și spune, măi omule, cum trăim noi aici?
And she said, husband, how can we live here?
De ce ne-a pedepsit Dumnezeu pe noi așa tare?
Why did God punish us this way?
Noi am dat averea pentru Dumnezeu.
We lost all of our wealth for God.
Noi am dat viața pentru Dumnezeu.
You almost lost your life for God.
Și Dumnezeu ne-a adus în țara asta.
And God brought us to this country.
Și nu avem măcar un nicul ca copii.
And we don't have a bed to let the children sleep in.
Zic, măi, femeie, Dumnezeu ar să îngrijească.
I said, wife, God will provide.
Păi tot timpul așa spui tu.
That's what you've always said, she says.
Du-te la alți americani care scrie for rent.
Go to other Americans where it says for rent.
Și spune-le ca să ne primească, că aici noi nu putem să stăm.
Ask if they'll let us in, because we can't live here.
Și m-am dus la alți americani unde scria for rent.
And I went to buildings where it said for rent.
Și am întrebat dacă ne primești.
And I'd ask if they'd let us in.
El primul cuvânt m-a întrebat dacă aveți copii.
The first thing they'd ask is if we had children.
Zic, da, avem.
Oh, yes, we do.
Cu copii nu primim.
Well, we don't accept people with children here.
Bă, zic, ce fel de oameni sunt?
Man, what kind of people are these?
Câinii țin în casă, zic, și copii, nu.
They keep dogs in their homes that they won't accept children.
Am început să plâng, frate.
And I began to cry, brothers.
America creștină.
I thought all of America was Christian.
Biblele ne-au venit din America.
All the Bibles came from America.
Misionarii au venit din America.
All the missionaries came from America.
Și cum ei nu ne primește cu copii în casă?
Yet they won't let us in because we have kids.
De ce m-a adus Dumnezeu pe mine aici?
Why did God bring me here?
Și am început să plâng, frate.
And I began to cry, brothers.
A venit la nevastă.
I came to my wife.
Nevasta m-a cunoscut că am plâns.
My wife noticed that I'd been crying.
Mai omule, de ce ai plâns?
Husband, why have you been crying?
Wife,
do you see me crying? I'm not crying now.
She
said, look, I've been with you too long. They won't let us in because we have kids, I said. She began to cry even worse.
Eu am plecat de lângă ea.
I had to leave.
M-am învârtit roată în prejurul blocului.
So I began walking around the building.
Și făceam verificarea vieții mele.
Checking out my life.
Zic, poate eu am supărat pe Dumnezeu.
Maybe I offended God with something.
Și Dumnezeu m-a pedepsit.
And this is my punishment.
Era noaptea târziu.
It was very late at night.
Stăteam pe o piatră afară.
I was sitting outside on a rock.
Lui Stan i-am arătat piatra când a fost la mine.
As Stan said, I showed him the rock when he came to my home.
Acolo stăm și mă gândeam ce am făcut eu.
And I was just thinking, what did I do?
Plângeam să nu mă vadă familia.
I was crying so my family wouldn't see me.
Deodată am văzut că vine o lumină spre mine.
And all of a sudden I saw a light coming towards
me. Când am văzut lumina, am crezut că e o mașină.
When I saw the light, I thought it was a car.
În Italia și în România m-au urmărit cu mașina să mă omoare.
Because in Romania and in Italy they always try to run me over with cars.
Zic, au venit după mine și aici.
So I thought they found me here too.
Dar n-a fost mașină.
But it was not a car.
Că lumina m-a cucerit.
The light surrounded me.
Și din lumină am auzit aceeași voce.
And out of the light I heard the same voice.
Era același înger.
It was the same angel.
Dimitru, de ce ești tu disperat?
Dimitru, why are you so despaired?
De ce m-ai pedepsit așa?
Why'd you punish me so harshly?
Ce am făcut eu?
What did I do?
Ce nu m-ai lăsat pe mine în pușcărie?
Why couldn't you let me stay in prison?
Familia avea unde să stea.
But my family would have had a home.
Zic, eu n-am unde îmi pleca cap.
I don't have a bed to lay my head down on.
De ce m-ai adus aici?
Why was I brought here?
Dumitru, te-am adus aici că țara asta va arde.
Dimitru, I brought you to this country because this country will burn.
De ce m-ai adus să mă arzi aici și nu m-ai lăsat să mor în pușcărie în țara mea?
So why'd you bring me here to burn? Why didn't you let me die in jail in my own country?
Dumitru, taci.
He said, Dimitru, be quiet.
Tu urcă-te lângă mine.
Get beside me.
Ce aparat a avut, nu știu.
I don't know what the device was.
M-a tras lângă el.
But he pulled me beside him.
Mi-a arătat toată California.
And he showed me all of California.
Deci îți arăt.
Do you see what I've shown you?
E Sodoma și Gomorra.
This is a Sodom and Gomorrah.
Păcatul lor a ajuns înaintea lui Dumnezeu.
Their sins have reached God.
Și Dumnezeu a hotărât să-i pedepsească prin foc.
And God has decided to punish them by fire.
M-a dus și mi-a arătat Las Vegas.
He came and showed me Las Vegas.
Aici e Sodoma și Gomorra.
This is a Sodom and Gomorrah.
Într-o zi va arde.
And one day it will burn.
Mi-a arătat New York.
He came and showed me New York.
Aici e New York.
This is New York. This is a Sodom and Gomorrah.
Într-o zi va arde.
In one day it will burn.
M-a dus și mi-a arătat Florida.
And then he showed me Florida.
Aici e Florida.
This is Florida.
Aici e Sodoma și Gomorra.
This is a Sodom and Gomorrah.
Într-o zi va arde.
And in one day it will burn.
Zic, da, cu mine ce ai să faci?
But what will you do with me, I said.
Ți-am spus să taci.
I told you to be quiet.
Și m-a dus la locul de unde m-a luat.
And he brought me back to the place we left.
Acum stai de vorbă cu mine.
He said, now we can talk.
Te-am adus în țara asta.
I brought you to this country.
Iubesc țara asta.
Because I love this country.
Iubesc poporul din țara asta.
I love the people in this country.
Și prin gura ta vreau să trezesc mult.
And through your mouth I want to wake up a lot of people.
Cum ai să-l trezești prin gura mea când eu nu pot să mă înțeleg cu nimeni?
How can you wake him through my mouth when I can't understand anyone?
Tu nu te îngrijora, zici.
You don't worry about that.
Eu îți voi pregăti prin cine se vorbește.
I'll prepare some more for you to speak through.
Aici ajungi la televizor.
You reach television.
Aici ajungi la radio.
Radio.
Aici ajungi în adunări.
Churches.
Să spui tot ce îți spun
eu. But tell them everything I tell you.
America va arde.
Again, he said, America will burn.
Cum să ardă America, că America e puternic.
But how can America burn when it's so powerful, I said.
Tu așa să le spui cum
îți spun eu. Tell them as I tell you.
Să n-ascunzi nimic, că dacă ascunzi aspru.
Hide nothing. If you will try to hide anything, I will punish you harshly.
Spionajul sovietic.
The Russian spies.
Au descoperit cele mai puternice depozite nucleare americane.
Have figured out where the most powerful nuclear plants in America are.
Când americanii cred că e pace, liniște.
When the Americans will think it's peace and quiet.
Și stăpânesc tot pământul.
And they rule the world.
Atunci de pe ocean.
Then from the ocean.
Cuba,
out of Cuba,
Nicaragua,
America
Central,
Central America,
Mexico,
Mexico.
Va bombarda depozitele nucleare americane.
They will bombard the nuclear plants in America.
Și America va lua foc.
And America will burn.
Dar ce faci cu biserica?
I said, but what will you do with the church?
Oh, zice, biserici, unele biserici m-au părăsit.
He said, many churches have left me.
Cum tu n-ai oameni aici?
I said, what do you mean? Don't you have people here?
Tot așa să le spui.
He said, tell them this.
Oamenii se slăvesc pe oameni.
People glorify people.
Cinstea care se cuvine să o dea lui Hristos.
The honor that Christ deserves.
Oamenii și-o iau asupra lor.
Men take upon themselves.
În biserică.
In the church.
Divorțul.
There's divorce.
Prea curvie.
There's adultery.
Sodomie.
There's sodomy.
Avortul.
There's abortion.
Și tot felul de păcate.
And all kinds of sin.
Și Hristos nu locuiește în păcat.
And Christ will not live in sin.
Hristos locuiește în sfințenie.
Christ lives in holiness.
Și te-am adus aici să strigi în gura mare.
And I brought you here that you cry out loud.
Să se oprească de a păcătui.
Tell them to stop sinning.
Să se întoarcă către Dumnezeu.
And to repent.
Că Dumnezeu nu obosește.
Because God never stops forgiving.
Amen.
Amen.
Și toți aceia.
And all those
care se vor opri de la păcatele lor.
Who will stop sinning.
Se vor întorna către Dumnezeu.
And who will repent?
În ziua nenorocirii voi salva.
God will save in the day of trouble.
Cum ai să-i salvezi dacă arzi America?
How can he save them if America burns, I
tot
said.
Le spui.
He said, tell them this.
Cum am salvat pe Daniel din groapa leilor?
As I saved Daniel from the lions.
Îi voi salva și pe ei.
This is how I will save them.
Cum am salvat pe cei trei tineri din cuptorul cu foc?
As I saved the three young ones from the furnace.
Îi voi salva și pe ei.
This is how I will save them.
Și cuvântul lui Dumnezeu spune așa.
And the word of God says this.
1000 va cădea alături de
tine. 1000 will fall to your side.
10000 la dreapta ta.
And 10,000 to your right.
Dar de tine nu se va atinge.
Yet no man will touch you.
Fiindcă suntem păziți de puterea lui Dumnezeu.
Because we are protected by the power of God.
Îngerii lui Dumnezeu tăbăresc.
And the angels of God are around those that fear him.
Dar trebuie să ai o viață curată.
But brother, your life must be clean.
Amen.
Amen.
Dacă tu ești îngerul lui Dumnezeu.
If you are truly the angel of God.
Și tot ce îmi spui tu nu e scris în Biblie.
Everything you say to me must be written in the Bible.
Eu pot să greșesc la americani.
If it is, then I can say this to the Americans.
Dar dacă nu scrii în Biblie, nu pot.
If it's not in the Bible, I won't say a word.
Tu ai citit în Ieremia?
Have you read Jeremiah?
Da, am citit.
Yes, I have.
Ai citit în 51 Ieremia?
Did you read Jeremiah 51?
Zic, am citit.
Of course I have.
Ce înțelegi acolo?
What did you understand?
Păi vorbește despre Babilonul vechi.
It speaks about the old Babylon, I said.
Oh, să mai citești o dată.
He said, read again.
Să mai citești o dată.
Read again.
Că spune despre America.
Because it speaks about America, not Babylon of old.
Apocalipsa 18 ai citit?
Have you read Revelation 18?
Am citit, zic, tot cu privire la Babilon.
I said, yes, it's also about Babylon.
No, ia să mai citești o dată.
He said, read it again.
Ca să-ți deschid mintea să înțelegi.
I will open your mind and you will understand.
Eu vă spun să citiți din Ieremia 51, versetul 7.
Brothers, let's read out of Jeremiah 51.
Începem cu 7.
We'll start with verse 7. And it says, Babylon was a golden cup in the Lord's hand that made all the earth drunk. The nations drank her wine, therefore the nations are deranged.
Amen. Babilonul
Babylon
a fost un potir de aur în mâna Domnului.
Was a golden cup in the Lord's hand.
Care au fost Babilonul? Arabii?
Now, are the Arabs Babylon?
Care nu cred în Dumnezeu?
Those that don't even believe in God?
Noi nu înțelegem.
Let's try to understand.
Care e Babilonul?
Who is Babylon?
Potirul de aur, spune David, cuvântul tău, Doamne.
At one point David says, your word, O Lord,
e mai de preț ca aur.
Is more precious than gold.
America a avut cuvântul lui Dumnezeu la bază.
America had the word of God in its hand.
America s-a încrezut în Dumnezeu.
America trusted in God.
America a avut misionari.
America had missionaries.
America a dus Biblia în toată lumea.
America spread the gospel throughout
Mulți
the world.
Mulți oameni s-au pocăit.
Many people came to God.
Dar America a căzut.
But America itself fell from the truth.
Ne întrebăm.
And we ask ourselves,
America a căzut, fraților.
Has America fallen from the truth, brothers?
Și acum ne întreabă, zice, am vrut să vindic Babilonul.
And further down it says, we would have healed Babylon.
Dar nu s-a vindicat.
But she is not healed.
Nu, hai, părăsește și hai fiecare în țara.
Forsake her, everyone.
Că pedeapsa lui s-a apropiat.
For her punishment is near.
Și ca să noi să ne încredințăm că e America.
Oh, so that we know it is America.
Să citim versetul 13.
We'll jump to verse 13. O you who dwell by many waters, abundant in treasure, your end has come, the measure of your covetousness.
Tu care locuiești între api mari.
Again, you who dwell by great waters.
Lăcomia ta a ajuns la capăt.
Abundant in treasure.
Dumnezeu hotărât să-ți pui sfârșit.
Your end has come.
Și 14.
And verse 14.
Te voi împlea de oameni ca de lăcuți.
Surely I will fill you with men as with locusts.
Și voi scoate strigăte de război împotriva.
Who will shout cries of war against you?
Oricare țară umplut-o Dumnezeu de
oameni. Which country is filled with men?
În care țară?
Which country does everyone come to?
Care vrea să emigreze la Hussein?
Who wants to immigrate to Iraq, to Hussein's country?
Întreabă-i care vrea să emigreze în America, pe alții.
But ask other people who wants to immigrate to America.
Văzând că din America au venit atâtea lucruri bune.
Because they see that all the good things come from America.
Oh, acolo e Dumnezeu.
Oh, that's where God is.
Așa cum am zis eu, că America trebuie să fie de morți.
I thought God resurrected the dead in this country.
Nu mi-am dat seama că atâta stricăciune.
I would never have believed such wickedness could exist here.
Oh, când m-am dus la o adunare americană.
I went to an American church in California.
M-am dus cu gândul că ar să mă ajute frații să-mi dea un pat.
And I went, you know, maybe the brothers would help me get a bed. But they were having prayer for the sick. So I thought to myself, my legs still hurt. I'm
going to
go and ask them to pray for me also. But I saw two guys with a blanket. I wonder what they're going to do with the blanket. Oh, you're going to see. And an old lady walks up slowly. The guy smacks her in the forehead and then covers her with a blanket. When I saw this, I thought he'd killed the old woman. I went and I tried to lift the blanket. Man, what's this? But the pastor runs to me.
Go, go, go!
No, don't!
Deci chem poliția.
I'll call the police if you don't leave.
Eu m-am uitat la dânsul, așa și am spus.
I look at him and I told him.
Poliția e Dumnezeu tău.
Is the police your God?
Dar Dumnezeu unează că e în cer.
Because my God's in heaven.
Adevărată rugăciune pentru bolnavi.
Brothers,
fratelor,
true prayer for the sick.
Știți cum se face?
How is it done?
Dacă cineva dintre voi bolnav.
If any of you is sick.
Spune apostolul Iacob.
Apostle James says.
Să cheme presbiterii bisericii.
Call upon the elders of the church.
Să ungă cu unde lemn în numele Domnului.
To anoint them with oil in the name of Christ.
Rugăciunea făcută cu credință.
And the prayer made with faith.
Va mântui pe cel bolnav.
Will make holy the sick.
Și Domnul va însănătoși.
And the Lord will heal them.
Și dacă au făcut păcate.
And if they have sinned.
Ei vor fi iertați.
They will be forgiven.
Dar mărturisiți-vă păcatele unii altora.
Confess your sins to one another. And pray for one another that you may be healed. You come before the pastor to be prayed for nothing. If you don't confess your sins, if you've sinned. Once you've confessed, you've received your healing. Brothers, read the holy book. It teaches you everything you must do. Not hitting him over the head and covering him with blankets. God doesn't heal that way. Not like I see people like blowing on people and then they're supposed to fall down. Brothers, I can say that's not of God. God is a wise God. And he is a God full of power. All he does is order and it happens.
Amen.
Like it so far? Then I'll continue. We'll go to Revelation 18.
Am vrut să vindic Babilonul.
We would have healed Babylon again. It didn't want to.
Versetul 4.
And verse 4.
Poporul meu.
My people.
Ieșiți din lumea aceasta.
Come out of this world.
Ca nu cumva să luați parte și voi la pedeapsa.
That you may not partake of his punishments.
Tu care zici că ești împărăteasă.
And then further down. Verse 7, I think.
Stai, zici, noi ne încredem în Dumnezeu.
You who say sits as a queen.
Oh,
we trust in God. The church was created here. Brother, we'll be taken up before any tribulation.
It
says, for that, says the Lord. In one day, will come hunger, famine, and you will be utterly destroyed by fire. Because you say you have God. Because you say, oh, I go to church, but I still smoke, and I still divorce, and I still drink. I still live as the world does. And whoever loves the world and the things of the world, the love of the Father is not within them. If you want to have the love of God in your heart, brother, you must live your life with God.
Amen? Îmi pare bine că ziceți amin.
I'm happy that you say amen.
Continuăm mai departe.
We'll continue further.
Spune tot aici în 18.
Also, Revelation 18
says
that it could prove it's America.
Vai, vai, Babilonul cel mare.
Whoa, whoa, the great Babylon.
Cetatea cea mare.
The great city.
Care toți negustorii de pe mare.
Whom all the merchants of the sea became wealthy from your spoils.
Toți împărații pământul au curvit cu tine.
All the kings of the earth committed adultery with you.
Într-o singură ceas a venit sfârșitul.
In one hour your destruction has come.
Începe să-și dea cu țărână în cap.
And it says they will put ash on their heads.
Tu care aveai toate, le cumpărai toată marfa.
You who bought merchandise from all over the world.
Argintul și toate lucrurile scumpe.
Gold and silver and things that were precious.
Apoi câte mașini are America și câte fabrici de mașini?
Now, how many car factories do Americans own?
Vedeți că scrie că o lua și Yugo de la Jugoslavia.
They had to import the Yugo from Yugoslavia.
Ca să se împlinească cuvântul lui Dumnezeu.
So that the word of God come to pass.
Or noi nu avem mintea asta să înțelegem.
Brothers, we have to think about these things.
Amen.
Amen.
Dumnezeu să vă lumineze mintea.
May God enlighten your minds, brothers.
Aș dori să ne întâlnim acolo sus.
Because I pray to see you up there.
Aș dori să ne vedem cu toți.
I pray that all of us make it.
Când vine Hristos să vă răpească.
That when Christ will return, he will take us up.
Jos.
That we will not be left behind.
Acum să vă spun din Israel că dacă frații doresc.
Well, a brother mentioned Israel.
Am avut îndemn să mă duc în Israel.
I've always felt that I wanted to go to Israel.
Dar nu știam eu singur de ce.
But I really didn't know why.
Și am dat telefon la niște frați în Israel.
I called some brothers I knew in Israel.
Au ieșit și m-au așteptat la aeroport.
They waited for me at the airport.
Eu m-am dus cu doi frați de-a lui.
I went with Mike's two little brothers.
Ei nu prea bine traduce.
Yeah, they can't translate very well.
Dar acolo trebuie să vorbească și ei.
But, you know, they knew how to speak anyway.
Și am ajuns în Ierusalim, am m-am localizat.
I got to Jerusalem, that's where they lived.
Dar am umblat să vizitez, să văd și eu locurile sfinte.
But I wanted to see all the holy places.
Să văd bisericile.
I wanted to see the churches.
Să văd locul pe unde a fost torturat Domnul Hristos.
I wanted to see the places where Christ walked and where he was tortured.
Dar n-aveai voie să deschizi gura să amintești de Hristos.
Yet you were not allowed to mention the name of Christ.
Am ajuns sabatul.
Sabbath came along.
S-au strâns acolo vreo 5 familii.
Some 5 families gathered in a room. And they celebrated it.
Dar nu cântat altă cântare.
But they sang no other song.
Decât Sabbath, Shalom, Sabbath, Shalom.
Except Sabbath and about Shalom. That's all they knew.
Eu spun, băi.
But I said to them,
voi în loc să vă rugați ca Dumnezeu să vă dea pacea.
Instead of praying for God to send you peace.
Voi vă rugați să vă dea sâmbătă pacea.
You pray for Saturday to give you peace.
Mai mult prețuiți o zi decât pe Dumnezeu.
A day will not save you, God will.
Nu le-o cam convenit lor.
They didn't really enjoy that.
Zic, du-mă să văd muntele maslinilor.
But I said, I want to go see the Mountain of Olives.
M-au dus să ne arate muntele maslinilor.
And they took me to see the Mountain of Olives.
N-aveai cum să te urci acolo.
You couldn't even get on it.
Roat împrejur, că dacă ați fost, ați văzut că era tot numai cimit morminte.
If any of you have ever been, all around the Mountain of Olives, there's just graves.
Eu întrebai, dar așa de mulți morți au murit aici în Israel?
And I asked, do these many people die in Israel?
Zice, nu frate.
He said, oh, no, brother.
Aici tot bogatașa din lume.
The rich people from all over the world.
Vin și-și cumpără cimitirul aici.
They come and they buy burial plots here. So that they get buried here. Because when the Messiah must return, they would come and meet him in the air. Oh man, you guys are charging these people for nothing.
Vezi de treabă, bă, că pentru noi a plătit mormântul Hristos.
Because Christ already paid for our burial plot.
Sângele lui Hristos ne-a curățat pe noi de păcat.
The blood of Jesus Christ has already cleansed us of sin.
Și când va veni Mesia la voi,
and when the Messiah returns,
noi îl întâmpinăm înainte istoriei. We
will meet him in the air, and these guys will still have their heads in the ground.
Orice.
They laughed.
Și au zis să merg cu ei la Marea Moartă.
And they said, come to the Dead Sea with us.
Am ajuns la Marea Moartă, așa de fierbinte era apa.
I got to the Dead Sea and the water was so hot that it almost boiled.
Eu m-am dezbrăcat să mă bag în apă.
I took off my clothes because I wanted to go in.
Au început să sune sirenele.
And the sirens began to blow.
Băi, zice, ieși afară.
I said, you have to get out.
Dar de ce?
Why?
Ce vine armata siriană.
Because the Syrian army is advancing.
În timpul cel ani, Dumnezeu ne-a arătat cum un înger al Domnului.
At that time, God showed me a vision.
Stătea pe muntele Golan.
An angel of the Lord stood on the Golan Heights.
Cu sabie în mână și a oprit pe sirieni.
With a sword drawn out, stopping the Syrian army from advancing.
Bă, zic, nu te teme, bă.
And I said, don't worry about it.
Domnului i-a oprit înaintea lor.
The angel of God has stopped them, they won't advance.
Ei speriați, toți
they were all scared, trying to get out of there as quick as possible. And I was sitting in the water, just laughing at them.
Când au văzut că nu au mai venit sirenii,
when they saw that nothing was happening,
păi, dar tu ai avut dreptate.
I said, you know what, you were right.
Nu eu, băi.
I said, it wasn't me.
Dumnezeu ne-a arătat să vă spun vouă.
It was what God showed me and what I should tell you.
Dar să știți că din partea aslantă venea o armată.
From the other side I saw another army.
Și bătea cu ghiulele drept în Ierusalim.
Attacking Jerusalem full force.
Cum, zice?
He said, what do you mean? I said, listen, you'll see.
Și chiar în noaptea aceea,
and that night,
Arafat a bătut cu cachiușa.
Arafat started bombarding Jerusalem.
Direct în Ierusalim.
Straight into Jerusalem.
Zice unul, băi, dar dacă mor tu aici?
And one of them says to me, what if you die here?
Bă, ajung și eu ca aștia, zic, să aproape de răpire.
I said, go bury me on the mountain, I'll be closer to the rapture.
M-a dus la zidul plângerii, frate.
They took me to the wailing wall.
Unde plângea Hristos.
Where Christ supposedly wept.
Când mă duc acolo, unul de-a lui Arafat a dat o bombă.
When I got there, one of Arafat's people set off a car bomb.
Cara morți, cara răniți.
They were taking away the wounded and the dead.
Zic, uite, băi, tot noi am scăpat.
I said, ah, we still escaped.
De acum a doua zi, zic, vreau să văd Bethlehem.
The next day I said I wanted to see Bethlehem.
Bethlehem e sub ocupația lui Arafat.
And as you know, Bethlehem is under Arafat's rule.
Zice, frate, n-ai cum să treci, că e granița.
Brother,
aici.
They will let you in, there's a border.
Băi, tu mă duci cu mașina.
I said, all I need for you to do is drive me there.
Nu te interesează, tu du-mă cu mașina.
None of your business how I get in, just
Dumnezeu
take me
there. Nu mi-a vorbit că mă duc să văd.
Because God spoke to me that I would see this place.
Când am ajuns la graniță, m-au înconjurat aceia cu puști.
I got to the border, they surrounded me with their guns.
Eu aveam o pălărie mare pe cap.
I had one of those big cowboy hats on my head.
Mă întreabă, tu de unde ești?
Ask, where are you from?
România.
Romania.
Oh, you welcome.
Oh,
you welcome.
Welcome, come on in.
Oh, oh. Zice, Arafat cu Ceaușescu, friend.
Arafat and Ceaușescu were good friends.
Și ne-a dat un delegat ca să ne arate, să văd tot.
They even gave me a delegate to show me around everything I wanted to see. And he'd explain to me where the manger was and where Christ was born and everything. When I got back, I told him, see, God was with me.
Și asta, fraților, 15 zile.
And I stayed there for 15 days.
Dar e o viață foarte încordată.
But it's a very tense life.
E foarte... Toată baba, tot copilul cu pușca.
Every child and every old woman's got a gun.
Când intram în Ierusalim, trebuia să-mi pun sclifiga pe cap.
When we'd enter Jerusalem, I'd have to put the little yarmulke on my head.
Ca să nu se leagă de mine.
So that nobody would mess with me.
Când intram între arabi, îmi puneam pălăria.
When I'd go among Arabs, I'd have to put on my cowboy hat.
Și Dumnezeu m-a păzit, frate.
But God protected us, brothers.
Am venit acasă, m-a rugat lui Dumnezeu.
I came home, I prayed to God.
Am întrebat de Dumnezeu, Doamne, ce ar să se întâmple?
And I asked God, Lord, what will happen?
Deocamdată zice, încă nu nimic.
He says, for now, nothing.
Numai unele ciocniri între ei.
They will just have small kirmishes between themselves.
Israel trebuie să se întoarcă către Dumnezeu.
But Israel must repent.
Fraților, Israelul nu-i creștin.
Brothers, Israel is not Christian.
Israelul caută să păzească legea veche.
Israel tries to keep the old laws.
Dar străcăciunii poate ca în America exact sau mai mult.
But there's so much wickedness there that it rivals even America.
Am dormit la un hotel și ce am văzut acolo.
I slept in a hotel one night and what I saw there terrified me.
Am zis că și aici e așa.
I said, even here these things could happen.
De ce numește Pământul Sfânt?
Why do they still call it the Holy Land?
Am văzut și adevărata poartă, modus unii nu au încercat tot să o deschidă și nu au putut să o
deschidă. I even visited the gate that everyone's tried to open and they couldn't open it.
Și spunea că ar să o deschidă Hristos.
And they said that the only one that can open it is Christ when he returns.
Și îl așteaptă să vină Hristos.
And they're all waiting for Christ to return.
Dar nu cred în el.
But they don't believe in him.
Ei așteaptă să vină Mesia.
They're waiting for the Messiah.
Dar nu-l crede pe Mesia.
But they don't believe in the Messiah.
Până nu-l crede.
And until they will not
nu
believe.
Nu poate să vină Mesia.
The Messiah will not return.
Și în cel ce a făcut Dumnezeu de cunoscut, Israelul va fi distrus.
And from the things that God has revealed to me, Israel will be destroyed.
Puțină rămășiță va fi salvat.
Only a small remnant of Israel will remain.
Dar acum la ora actuală toți imigranții din evrei din România,
but right
din
now,
Rusia,
all the Jews from Romania
Ungaria,
and Russia, Hungary, Czechoslovakia,
toți s-au dus acolo.
They're all going back home.
Stres prin corturi.
They live in tents.
Pământul l-a dat lui Arafat
americanii. The Americans gave all the land back to Arafat.
Și tot Israelul bat jocorește pe americani.
And Israel is now very, very mad against America.
Pentru că le-a luat pământul și l-a dat lui Arafat.
They took away their land and gave it to Arafat.
Acum noi să stăpânim moștenirea care ne-a dat-o Dumnezeu.
Brothers, now we have to keep the inheritance that
Dumnezeu
God gave to us.
Dumnezeu ne-a dat o moștenire.
Because God did give us an inheritance.
Moștenirea noastră nu e pe pământ.
Our inheritance is not here on earth.
Moștenirea acolo sus în cer.
Our inheritance is in heaven. Because that's where our names are written in the book of life. And if your name is not written, brothers, God showed me that there was one page left. And when this page is completed, even if you'll want to repent, you won't be able to. There is a short time. Brother, hurry. Make sure that your name is written in that book. Know that you will be part with Christ. Know that you'll be part of salvation. Because that's when the words of God will come to pass. 1,000 will fall to your side and 10,000 to your right. That's when Isaiah's prophecies will come to pass. They will say, we're going with you because God's with you.
It says
10 people will hang on to your clothes. Not Israel's clothes. Brothers, you are the new Israel. Those of you whose hearts have been circumcised. You are the new Israel. You were redeemed with the blood of Jesus Christ. And God sent Christ to die for us. That through his wounds we may receive healing. And if he healed you, and if he's healed me, brother, live your life in holiness. So that when Christ will return in the air, we will meet him there.
Și noi vom vedea cu ochii noștri.
And we will see with our own eyes.
Dacă Dumnezeu zice n-ar scurta zilele acelea,
it says, if God would not shorten the days,
din cauza celor neprihăniți,
for the sake of the elect,
n-ar mai scăpa niciunul.
No one would escape.
Așa o zi de groază vine.
That's a horrible day is coming.
Dar datorită aleșilor lui Dumnezeu,
but because of God's chosen,
Dumnezeu va mai scurta zilele.
God will shorten these days.
Fraților, mult nu mai este.
Brothers, it will not be long.
Puțin mai este.
Only a short time
remains.
Eu n-am
mai zis că vin în America.
I never thought I'd be back in America.
Eu am fost bolnav.
I was very ill.
Cum am
After I buried my wife, I became very ill. I was very mad. And I said, I will never return to America. And God spoke to me, go. Go, for I still have people to wake up. I still have people to save. American brothers, wake up. Wake up.
Sculați-vă din somn.
Wake from your sleep.
Și apropiați-vă de Dumnezeu.
And repent and return to God.
Că ziua cazului se apropie.
Because the day of wrath is near.
Și dacă vom fi cu Hristos.
And if you will be with Christ.
Oh, vom merge sus la Tata.
You will go to see the Father.
Unde nu va mai fi lacrimi.
Where there will be no tear.
Nu va mai fi boală.
Where there will be no disease.
Nu va mai fi moarte.
Where there will be no death.
Vom avea o bucurie veșnică.
Where we will have eternal joy.
Hristos se va încinge.
Christ will put on his belt.
Și ne va servi la masă.
And he will serve us at the table.
Dumnezeu să vă binecuvintează pe voi.
May God bless you.
Pe familiile voastre.
And your families. And I pray that as we see each other here, we will see each other in our Father's home.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Brother Dimitru Duduman and Michael Boldea. Now, as we hear all of this testimony, what do we do about it? My, how do we clean up? How can we get God's protection? Now, let's say, for example, you're at ground zero. How do you react? How do you react when the white flash of the bomb goes off? There are those who would say, run to the basement. I'd rather fall to my knees. Amen? So how do we prepare? The first thing we have to do to get God's protection is to be clean. He's only going to protect those people that are clean. So how do we clean all the sins off of our heart, all of the sins off of our soul? And how do we get our name written in the book of life? First of all, we have to realize that we're all sinners. Romans 3:23 says, for all have sinned to come short of the glory of God. We also have to realize we cannot earn salvation. We cannot earn all of our sins being washed away. It is a gift. Ephesians 2:8-9 says, for it is by grace you are saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is a gift from God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Okay, so if eternal life is a gift, if washing our sins off of our soul and out of our heart is a gift, then how do we reach out and take that gift? Romans 10:9-10 says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, but with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. What's that saying? It's simply saying it's not enough to say it with our mouth and not believe it with our heart. And it's not enough to believe it, but never say it. We've got to say it and we've got to believe it. Acts 2:38 says, repent and be baptized, every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. But we don't hear that repent word much anymore. So what is it? In my life, One day I sat down and decided I was going to follow God. And I sat down in a chair and I said, Lord, I made a mess of my life, but I'll tell you what, if you'll forgive my sins, if you'll give me another chance, if you'll wash me clean from here on out, I promise I'm yours. I'll learn your words, I'll learn your book, I'll learn your laws, and I'll do my best to follow them. That's what repentance is. It's a turning away from sin. It's a leaving the old life and following Jesus. That's repentance. And ask every one of you, and you folks watching the video, can you name a specific day, a specific time in your life when you asked Jesus into your heart? If you can't, you should be concerned. And ask yourself, was there a change in your life? If there was no change, you have to examine your heart and you have to ask, was I really saved? If there's no change, then you should be concerned. That's repentance. Holy Spirit, I ask you to go out into the audience and also to the folks watching the videotape, that those people's hearts would be knocked on right now, that you would knock on their hearts, all those people whose names you want to write in the book of life, those people that you want to clean all the sins off their soul so you can save them when the day of trouble comes, that they would make that decision now and not delay, in Jesus' name. Let's all bow our head, no one looking around. Yes, we may have prayed this prayer many times. It still feels good to say it again. We ought to even say it on a regular basis. So let's all say it. Dear Heavenly Father, I admit I'm a sinner, and I confess with my mouth, and I believe in my heart that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, died on the cross, arose 3 days later, sits at the right hand of the Father. I ask Him to forgive my sins, wash me clean, write my name in the book of life, save me in the day of trouble, and keep me holy. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, I like to be able to say that that's all you have to do, but that's not what the Bible says. Matthew 7:21 says, not everyone that cries, Lord, Lord, will enter into the kingdom of heaven, but those that doeth the will of the Father. What's the will of the Father? He says, be ye holy, for I am holy. He says, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. Amen? Now, it's not over in another way, because Matthew 10:32-33 says, whosoever confesses me before men, him will I also confess before my Father which is in heaven. But whosoever denies me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. In other words, God wants us to have a little steel in our backbone for a change and to stand up and say, either Lucifer is our God and act like it, or God, Jesus, one or the other. Does he not say in Revelation that I would that you would be either cold or hot, but because you're lukewarm, I'll spew thee out of my mouth? So he wants us to either be for Jesus or for Lucifer, one or the other. So I challenge every one of you tonight to make that decision, whom you will serve. Amen.